From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.69 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $293. And how War.com reports the province of Taiz in southern Yemen has been a battleground for weeks, with the Houthis controlling much of the city and fighting against a combination of local Sunni tribes and pro-Saudi forces loyal to the former Hadi government. Saudi warplanes got involved in a big way recently. As usual, the result was an absolute disaster as Saudi warplanes attacked and leveled a heavily populated residential neighborhood in the port city of Mocha, killing at least 120 civilians and wounding 150 others. The local hospital naturally was overwhelmed by this huge influx of casualties, and witnesses described animal-drawn carts dragging the badly burned bodies around to hospitals in the area. The provincial capital of Taiz, with its bigger facilities, is said to be unreachable because of heavy fighting along the road. Mocha is near the port city of Aden, which Hadi forces recently seized much of, and Saudi airstrikes began targeting the Houthi forces defending the town from a possible influx of fighters from Aden. 20 were reported killed in initial attacks before the residential areas started getting hit and quickly burst into flames. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, the nation's first naturally filtered chemical-free public pool opened on Friday in Minneapolis, Minnesota. The Weber Natural Swimming Pool boasts an organic filtration system which pumps pool water through a system of biological filters, including 7,000 aquatic plants. The result of a four-year project and $6 million in funding, the pool features a traditional shallow and deep end, as well as a deeper section with a jumping platform and lap lanes. The pool has a capacity of up to 500 people and is capable of holding over 500,000 gallons of water. The natural filtration system, which filters water through plants and gravel, pumps through all of the pool's liquid contents every 12 hours. Visitors to the pool can swim for free, although some strict rules are set to keep the system running smoothly. Minneapolis Parks and Recreation Board said in a statement, "This unique water management system is more sensitive than a traditional chemically treated pool and will require cooperation from the public to stay open." Outside food and drinks, tobacco, pets, and glass are prohibited from the pool area, while swimmers are limited to wearing nylon, silicone, latex, lycra, and polyester swimwear. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports the U.S. government is violating a 1997 settlement by detaining unauthorized immigrant children, and an order may be forthcoming to require the release of the minors and parents detained with them, according to a federal judge in California. The ruling on Friday by U.S. District Judge Dolly Gee follows an influx across the U.S.-Mexico border of immigrants from Central America. Department of Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson said earlier this summer the flood of immigrants has slowed from peaks last year, but is still high. The latest ruling on detentions represents a defeat for U.S. immigration authorities, who in court filings argued releasing undocumented immigrant children with their parents encourages families in Central America to undertake the dangerous journey north. The judge ordered U.S. officials to present arguments for why she should not issue a ruling to require the release of immigrant children and a parent, usually a mother, detained with the minor. The judge indicated a willingness to implement such a ruling within 90 days.
A prison rights group protests the treatment of supervillains in the nation's magnetic detainment cubes. A local dad thought he could make it out of a zoo without buying his kids light-up shit. movement, and a pigeon wishes just once it could complete a head movement smoothly. This is the Onion Week in Review. Millions of frustrated Americans across the country asked this week why the nation's struggling mental health system couldn't just get it together and stop feeling sorry for itself. Exasperated citizens told reporters that they had lost all patience with the ailing network's failure to perform basic tasks, such as routine mental health evaluations and emergency counseling.
Look, I get it. Everyone goes through a rough patch. Just look at the education system. I know times are tough, but things are never going to improve unless the system decides it wants to get better.
In other news, a new study finds that more men are opting to be in the room when their wife conceives their baby. An area man is unaware all of his friends think of him when they want to put things into perspective, and 36 chemical and emotional responses are activated by the phrase pigs in a blanket.
This is the Onion News Network.
And it's the live Sunday edition of the program. You can dial in toll free here, 855-450-FREE, to join us if you have a question for Dr. Mary Ruwart. She is our guest to start the show out here tonight. Mark, you actually had the pleasure of introducing Mary on stage about a week or two ago, actually at the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance Liberty Dinner. They do an awards dinner here. We've talked a lot about the Liberty Alliance as a really unique organization that doesn't exist in any other state. They rate all the bills. They rate the state reps based on, you know, are these people voting for liberty or not? And there's usually a few hundred folks, a couple hundred people that'll come to this dinner, and somebody speaks, and Dr. Ruwart was the speaker this year.
Yeah, a lot of times if a liberty organization's nearby and they can't afford an actual MC, they'll have me do it.
Yeah, sure.
And so my policy when it comes to MCing is hey, nobody came here to watch the MC, right?
Get off the stage.
Get off the stage. Right. I mean, that's really what I do. So I told a quick story about how Mary Ruwart's book, Healing Our World, is incredibly important for the Liberty community, so important that we recommend it here on the show far more often if people ask sort of, how do I get my family member on board with the ideas of Liberty? Mm-hmm. Well, hand them this book. If they're a reader, This book's great for them. It's called Healing Our World, and you can get it at book.freetalklive.com.
Yeah, or maybe it's books.freetalklive.com. I think either one will work. But yeah, it's a great book. You can actually get the audio version and PDF and other versions, like the mobile versions and things like that. You, Dr. Ruwart, welcome back to Free Talk Live. You've been so generous with Healing Our World and giving out the original 90s edition in so many different ways to people, and really, I think, contributing to changing a lot of minds towards the ideas of freedom. So I want to start out by saying thank you for all of your efforts.
Well, you're welcome. I mean, this was something that I felt, I don't know, I just had, how can I say it, almost a revelation about how to put this together. And I think it's meant to be shared. So I'm trying very hard to share it and yet not go bankrupt doing it.
It is, revelation might be the right word, because it really puts things in perspective. Ian, you actually voiced, is that right? You voiced a different book.
Or no, it was somebody else's. Yeah, I voiced Tannehill's. It was somebody else who voiced.
Over at books.freetalklive.com, we have the audio version too. Yeah.
Yes, that was a fan of mine who did it and sent it to me and said, use it as you wish. And so I felt that the best way to do it was to make it available.
Absolutely.
And hopefully I'll have an audio edition of the new one coming out in next month, but the audio edition won't be out for several months after the print version.
So we actually didn't have you on because you're coming out with a new book. That just happened to coincide with your appearance here in New Hampshire, and I'm excited about it. It's the same book, but reworked, right? Like, is it the third revision that's coming out?
The fourth. It's the fourth.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And new cover art, from what I understand as well, which is exciting.
Yes, and a new subtitle. It's called Healing Our World, The Compassion of Libertarianism.
Oh, cool.
And yeah, because, you know, that's the thing that we always get criticized about, that we're not compassionate, we don't care about the poor. And of course, it's just the opposite. Mm-hmm. Liberty helps the poor most of all. And that's the kind of thing I wanted to talk about in Healing Our World.
Isn't it true, though, Mary Ruwart, when you see a bum on the street, you kick him? I mean, isn't that like your favorite thing to do? Kick a bum.
No, I can't say that it is.
It's ridiculous. Libertarians just hate poor people and old people.
But since you went there, I mean, we can talk about the FDA. You've got a lot of experience in the FDA, and that was one of the things you spoke about at the dinner the other night. But since you went there about liberty helps the poor, I mean, there are people listening who might be recoiling at that statement, like, oh, yeah, right. You libertarians just want to keep all the tax, your tax money, and it's the government that's helping the poor. You want to get rid of welfare programs? I mean, come on. You can't be serious.
Well, I worked with welfare recipients for about 10 years, so I'm very knowledgeable in how things are handled. And basically what it does is it entraps the young people.
How
women,
so?
Well, women, when they get pregnant in high school, say, oh, you know, this is the way to establish my household. This is what I've been told by the people coming to rent for me. You know, now I'm going to have a baby in 6 months. So now I'll be able to have my own household. I'll get a rent check. And so, you know, I want to rent from you. Well, you know, in high school, that rent check and the little bit of cash you get looks pretty good. Hmm. So the young women drop out of school. They don't get married because if they get married, they can't get the welfare check. And then they realize, oh, this isn't going to work. It's too little money. I'll have a second child, so I'll get more. And a third child, so I get more. And in Michigan, where I was at the time, after the third child, there was no more money. And at that point, they go, oh, wait a minute. I'm going to be poor all my life. I don't want to do this. I'm going to go out and get a job. But then they have three children that need childcare. It's almost impossible unless they have a relative to take care of them.
Wow. And you've seen this by, weren't you renovating low-income housing at one
yes.
point?
Yes. And I had one tenant say to me, you know, Dr. Ruwart, you really need to stop working so hard. You work at Upjohn all day and you come and work on the apartments at night. You need to have some kids, get on welfare so you can have a life.
Wow.
Now, of course, yeah. Now, of course, not everybody thinks that way. The problem is, I think, more closely related to the first example I gave you, where the young women get trapped in this system and they can't get out.
It's horrible.
So when I was doing the emceeing, I wanted to thought it was really a compelling speech, and I wanted to see if I could get some of the information of that speech sort of out to the listeners, because you know, I don't think people know that there were some amendments. You kept talking about amendments. They're not obviously not constitutional amendments, but some amendments that that were passed in the 60s that essentially broke the medical system in the United States.
Yes, these were the amendments to the Food and Drug Act. They gave a lot of power to the FDA. And basically what they did after, you know, they came down is they increased the drug development time 10 years. It was about 4.5 years before the amendments. It's now about 14. And the cost continues to go up, even though the timeline has stabilized or gone down a little from that 14 years. So what happens is, first of all, everything has to be patented. When I started with Upjohn, we would develop some drugs that weren't patented, but because now the costs are so high, a drug company won't even consider developing anything unless it can be patented, which of course excludes nutrition and minerals and things like this that actually pharmaceutical companies were very involved in. They were some of the first companies to encourage people to take multiple vitamin supplements and things like that. But after the amendments passed, that just wasn't going to work anymore. It was too costly.
So it was the government that created Big Pharma.
That's right. And, you know, I was an AIDS researcher for part of this time. And, you know, what was happening is the AIDS patients couldn't wait. So they hired black market chemists to manufacture the very drugs we were working on. And by the time the FDA gave us permission to test in humans, every AIDS patient in the country that wanted our drugs had already had them and had resistance to them. So we had to wait for newly diagnosed patients to do the studies that the FDA required. And the cancer patients sued the FDA because they didn't want to go the black market route. They sued to be allowed to take drugs that had had safety testing in humans, but not effectiveness testing. And the courts ruled that the Constitution does not guarantee a right to life if it means that we have to use unapproved drugs.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Is that settled settled law at this point that you don't have a right to use unapproved drugs?
That's correct. Yes, the Supreme Court refused to hear it, so the lower court ruling stands. And I suspect that somebody is going to resurrect this somehow if they can do it with a little bit different angle. because patients are very upset about this. Now,
well,
with
it's
the internet,
stupid.
They know. Well, of course.
I mean, you know what's, what would be a terrible idea is if some, if one or 2% of terminally ill patients died a few days early because of some, you know, drug that they're testing out on themselves voluntarily.
Well, and there's so much good information that can come from that. But actually, it's very hard, even under the current system, there's something called compassionate use, where if the FDA blesses it, the company can give them the drug. But the company has a lot of disincentive to do that, because if anything goes wrong, these are terminally ill patients, right? So if anything goes wrong and the patient dies, which, you know, there's
a
high probability.
Yeah, we're all going to die.
Then the FDA says, oh, maybe the drug was toxic. And so they make the company do more studies.
I see.
Mary, can you hang on? Stick with us for a little bit?
Sure.
All right, more with Dr. Mary Ruwart here in moments. She's here, and you can join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And also, well, actually, you can't join us on Skype. You can join us on Skype later, because she's on Skype right now. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live's Live Sunday Edition.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Friends, this is Alex Jones for MidasResources.com. For more than 15 years, I have exclusively used Midas Resources for all my precious metal needs. Whether it's bullion or collectibles you're looking for, Midas Resources is simply the best. I own my gold as a hedge against inflation. This Federal Reserve fiat currency could go the way of the Deutschmark and the Weimar Republic anytime. In these historically dangerous times, it makes sense to physically hold gold and silver. Midas already has some of the best deals in the industry. But if you give them a call and mention the radio special, they will give you a list of the day's super specials. Midas brokers are standing by to answer all your questions at 800-686-2237. They also have a lot of informative free literature explaining the opportunities and risk of holding precious metals. They are ready to answer your questions at 800-686-2237. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
If worst comes to worst, Will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Welcome back to more Free Talk Live. You can, of course, bring up anything that you want here, although right now your questions should be for Dr. Mary Ruwart. Otherwise, we're going to make you wait because, you know, she's a special guest, and we don't really have guests on the show very often, if at all. So it's nice to have her actually back on Free Talk Live.
And it's not like she can't answer any of your questions about the ideas of liberty,
she
right?
She wrote
like,
the book on that, Mark. Yeah. She wrote the book, Tough Answers to, or Tough Questions. Oh,
short,
darn it, I forget.
Answers. Short Answers to the Tough Questions.
Yes, it's an excellent book. It's just been a long time since I've
You've
read
been
it.
Handing that out. You bought a case of them and handed
no,
them out.
No, I didn't buy a case of those. I bought a case of Healing Our World.
Did you? Yeah. Oh, my mistake.
So, but which is, in my opinion, an even more important book. So, but great author, and it's great to have you back here on Free Talk Live. We're going to continue with talking. I want to come back around to the issue of the poor, because I feel like we never really... Mark, you jumped in with questions about the FDA, and like, we can talk about the FDA, and I'm fine with that, but I think the you know, people... really don't understand libertarianism and how it can help the poor, and we never really got to how it can help. We talked about how welfare hurts, or can put people in a bad place, but, you know, some people would say, well, you know, you guys just want to throw the baby out with the bathwater. So I want to get back into that too with you, Mary, if you've got time for us. So,
sure.
But first, I want to remind our listeners about ExpressCoin.com, and I'm going to put you on the spot. Mary, do you have a Bitcoin wallet set up yet?
No, I don't, and I need one. And now that I've heard about your great offer, we were on break, I typed it in so I wouldn't forget it.
I don't know what the offer is. That
Purse.freetalklive.com?
Oh,
yes,
Purse. Okay,
yes,
great.
Yes, Purse. Yes,
yeah, Purse
yes.
is pretty awesome. And in fact, I was going to talk about ExpressCoin, which is a way to actually get the Bitcoins that you can then spend on Purse and get 20, 25% off of Amazon. So if you go to ExpressCoin.com, they actually take check or money order. And so you
whether
mail
in
out
the U.S. or Canada.
In the U.S. or Canada. So you mail out a check, they send you Bitcoin or Litecoin or Dogecoin or something else like that. It's fast, safe, easy, and it's inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get started right now right through their website, or if you want, download their app at ExpressCoin.com. If you use coupon code FTL, you get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee. So you could buy $40 worth of Bitcoin, pay zero transfer fee on it, and then take that $40 worth of Bitcoin and go buy something on Amazon at 20 or 25% off or possibly more through purse.freetalklife.com. It's a great combo of websites, and these are really killer apps for Bitcoin. So ExpressCoin.com. And for people that are thinking about getting a Bitcoin wallet, I do recommend the Airbits wallet, AIRBITZ, for anyone who has a smartphone device. The Airbits wallet is the best choice, in my opinion. It's cool. You open it up, it'll actually show you where local businesses are that accept Bitcoin. So somewhere you can physically walk into and go and buy things. Like here in Keene, New Hampshire, you can go to the corner store right in the heart of downtown Keene, and you can buy anything in the store for Bitcoin, which is pretty awesome. So go check it out at ExpressCoin.com, and don't forget the Airbits wallet. Dr. Ruwart, you were talking about the FDA and sort of the past, the nasty, ugly history of the government regulation of medicine, and how it's hurting competition, which ultimately hurts you know, the ability to have good solutions and choices in the marketplace to help people.
But didn't you, Ian, you wanted to find out how you wanted to ask her how you know, the ideas of liberty can help the poor first.
Right. We were talking about the FDA, though, Mark, because you had changed gears into the FDA in the last segment. So we're going to come back around to the poor.
All right.
Since we were talking about the FDA, figured we'll wrap that up. Dr. Ruwart, are you still
yes.
with us?
Yes, I am. So what exactly did you want me to address first?
Yeah, so
I got a little confused on that.
Right, so the FDA, you know, the whole point being that they have hurt people that they were supposedly set up to help.
Yes, yes. And, you know, the 10-year delay, for example, probably has cost about 4 million Americans years of their lives. And there's a lot of innovation that's destroyed too because of the high costs. You know, I was actually called by the FDA one time to talk about the prostaglandins and liver disease that I was doing research on, and they wanted to actually help the company, my company I worked for, get the drug out the door because there was nothing for liver disease. But the problem is when you have a new treatment for a disease that doesn't have one, you don't know how long you need to treat, especially if it's a chronic disease like liver disease. You don't know how much drug you need to give. You don't know how often you need to give it. And when you don't know how many people you're going to need to see a big enough difference that it'll be statistically significant enough for the FDA. And if you guess wrong on any of these things and you do your studies for several years and then find out that it's not quite right and you have to do it over, your patent's gone. And so what that means is you can't recover your costs, and only about 3 out of 10 drugs today recover their costs. So what the industry is depending on is these blockbuster drugs. So a lot of innovation doesn't happen. And that probably costs us even more than the delays. I estimate between 4 and 16 million people have had their lives shortened in the U.S. And all this kind of ripples outward into the world because most drugs are made in the U.S. So if there's something that doesn't get to market that should get to market in the U.S., it probably isn't going to get, except in unusual cases, get to the market overseas. And that means the whole world suffers.
So basically, the regulation pushes out the little guy. There can't really be somebody who's like an independent researcher who can go and do this kind of research. They don't have the billions that it takes to get through the process. So it really whittles it down to just a few players.
14 years worth of testing, right?
Yes, that's the average for a new, what we call a new chemical entity, which, you know, I think you would think of as a new drug that isn't similar to anything else on the market.
Now, I've heard that what companies will do is, in order to play it safe, because of the patent process, because of these rules that the FDA has, they'll change the chemical formulation of a drug that has run out of patent, and then just basically reintroduce a new and improved version with a new and improved patent.
They'll try, yes. I mean, obviously, what's happening, you're seeing all this merging with the companies because it costs out of pocket. This isn't even counting interest, right? Out of pocket, it costs about $1.5 billion to develop a new drug. Not many companies can take a hit like that if the FDA says no at the last minute. So companies are merging, and it makes sense for them to play it safe, to do just what you're describing, or to continue to work in a class of drugs where there's already a lot of drugs out there. But if they can get a small percentage of the market with a minor improvement, you know, that would be good. Also, it encourages them to only develop drugs that people will have to take for years and years, because it's the only way, again, they can recover their costs. Mm. And the problem with that is if you're taking a drug for years and years, there's much more chance you're going to have side effects, really bad side effects.
So the FDA is essentially, people are expecting life extension to happen in the relatively near future, and, you know, short decades here. But the FDA is keeping medical advancements at bay with all of its rules.
That's right.
What can we do? That you've said that the Supreme Court has said that the American people, do not have a right to basically the drugs that we want to get. The FDA, this government agency that isn't mentioned in the Constitution, is completely constitutional and can keep people from getting access to these drugs, which seems like a crazy ruling, but, you know, whatever. We're not the Supreme Court. And, it's just stifling innovation. This is the biggest medical market in the world, right?
Yes, and it has stifled. We were on the verge of a golden age of health in the 60s, and these amendments really put a halt to that.
Mary, can you stay with us for another segment?
Sure.
All right, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We will come back and talk about the issue of helping the poor without the state. Can that make it better? Can that make life better for people in a tough spot? 855-450-FREE. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. Radio remains the most intimate of all forms of media. At home, at work, in the car, on smartphones. Over 90% of consumers still listen to radio every week. That makes choosing radio as a place to advertise your business one of the best decisions you can make. Email advertise@gcnlive.com and partner up with an experienced GCN representative. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Attention business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO? MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. People are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can join us here. We've got Dr. Mary Ruwart with us on the Skype. So you can call in with questions at 855-450-FREE. That's toll-free, 855-450-3733. She's the author of Healing Our World, one of my favorites. Definitely an eye-opening book for people who aren't quite there yet with the ideas of freedom. friends or family members that you've been wanting to persuade. This is a very persuasive book. I highly recommend it. Though that's not the reason we're having her on. She was actually speaking here in New Hampshire at an awards dinner for the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance recently. And Mark, you used that opportunity to invite her back on the show. So it's great to have her here again with us. And she did mention purse.freetalklive.com, one of our advertisers. And an organization that I had been utilizing before they came on board with Free Talk Live, long before that. I started like 6 months ago with Purse. It was actually Roger Veer's recommendation, aka Bitcoin Jesus. He recommended Purse. I got on and immediately started saving 20%+ on everything I bought on Amazon. I've now done 24 transactions through Purse and have saved over $500. So, I mean, I could have paid all $500 of those dollars to Amazon, but I kept those in my pocket because I went to purse.freetalklive.com and got signed up there. And you can do the exact same thing. If you're willing to be a little patient with buying things on Amazon, you can save big. And usually you don't have to wait more than a day.
And you have to get Bitcoin. I mean, that's the other
Oh, yeah, that's aspect. The catch. Yeah. You do have to pay with Bitcoin, which, of course, it's easy to get Bitcoin. And this gives you a reason to get some if you haven't yet done so already. So go to purse.freetalklive.com and get deep, deep discounts on anything you want to buy through Amazon at purse.freetalklive.com. Dr. Ruwart, thank you for staying on here with us tonight. And we were discussing both the FDA and also helping the poor, which is something that you focus on a lot in Healing Our World, as to how libertarianism is the most compassionate solution. And whether it's helping people get access to affordable medications through not destroying the industry with regulation, or helping people in a bad spot in life, you know, actually climb up the ladder of affluence, getting the government out of the way is the best thing that we can do. So to come back around to the discussion we'd had with you about helping the poor, you did give some examples of how welfare can sort of trap people in the system and not allow them to really grow as people and you know, put themselves out there and start businesses or get a job because they're trapped by the rules of welfare, sort of. But that's not really an argument against welfare. Somebody could say, well, you know, the system could be run better, and we still need the government to help these people. How can you libertarians want to take away people's welfare programs?
Well, actually, private programs give about close to 65-70% of what they take in to the poor, whereas government programs only give about a third of what they take, what they assign, you know, of our taxes to help the poor. The poor only get about a third of that, if that. Mm. So, you know, it's much more efficient through the private sector. But that is not the main reason that Liberty helps the poor. I will make a bold statement and then try to explain it a little bit. And the bold statement is most poverty in the world today is caused by lack of liberty or government aggression.
Yeah.
And to give you some examples, I'm going to talk about two of my tenants who were actually, you know, they were low-income tenants, but they were working. One was sewing curtains in her home, and the other one was doing childcare for the other members of, you know, the other tenants of the apartment complex. And neither of these people created any extra traffic or anything. I was happy with them doing that. Mm-hmm. But the city government wasn't. They got on their case because they didn't have a license, and they wouldn't have gotten one because the apartment was not zoned for commercial use.
Right.
And the ceilings weren't as high as they needed to be for the childcare and things like that.
Where are your sprinklers? You need fire sprinklers.
Right. So what ended up happening is, you know, the city called me and asked me to evict them because of that. And of course, I told them no, I wasn't going to do that. And yet they kept bothering these poor women who finally just threw in the towel and said, you know, well, what are we going to do then to the city officials? They said, well, what you need to do is quit what you're doing and go on welfare. And that's what they ended up doing because, you know, the city officials didn't want them having a business there. And here they were supporting themselves and they ended up on welfare. It's nuts. You know, it's really nuts.
That's a tragic story. And there's no shortage of those stories, right? I mean, there are a lot of people who have had the mind of, oh, I want to start my own business. And then, of course, they're told, well, you need to do it the right way, which, of course, means to go and beg government bureaucrats for permission to provide a product or service to people on a consensual basis. And when you start doing that, when you start looking into it, whatever it is, it's always incredibly high barriers, things that make it very, very difficult, as you were explaining, to actually just start doing even a home-based business in some places can be super difficult to get started with.
Yeah, we call this like kicking the bottom rungs out of the ladder of success. And what I find is that those on the left, right, the ones that care very much about these issues, you know, I care about them too, but the ones, you know, they just sort of take the what they take what they've been told throughout life. They just don't seem to believe it. When you say that, look, the government comes in and they make it impossible for these people to make a living on their own, and then they give them a welfare check. They essentially just say, these people can't. They can't earn their own money, so we have to give it to them. And I think it's insulting as hell. But how do you convince people that just won't listen?
Well, I mean, if somebody isn't going to listen, obviously nothing's going to work. Mm-hmm. But I have had success telling this story at meetings, very much like the one we were at Sunday. And I actually had a woman who was about in her 60s, I think, come up to me afterwards and say, oh, my goodness, you know, all my life I've been voting for the wrong things because I really wanted to help the poor. And now I realize, you know, it's just the opposite. You know, what can I do? And we had just a really intense, close moment. And we hugged and I said, well, you know, you've got the rest of your life, you know, to make it right. And she was, that was evidently the right thing to say to her because she got a big smile on her face and said she would do that. Aww. I actually debated someone, you know, I used to run as a Libertarian Party candidate against a state rep in Kalamazoo. I ran against her 3 times and we talked about these very things, helping the poor. And she finally stopped me on the street one time and says, you know, I've been a liberal, as you know, all my life and voted for these things, but I voted this time to privatize the welfare system because, you know, you've convinced me that it's so inefficient. So that was very
You convinced a politician. That's quite a
yeah. I shudder to think what this privatization looked like, though. You know, when they talk about privatization with the government, it's like, oh,
devil's
no.
Devil's in the details right. On that one for sure. Well, that's a good story, though. I mean, it really, you know, shows that you can actually have an effect by getting into the political race. You actually ran for president under the Libertarian Party, or you attempted to, but unfortunately were defeated by someone who really shouldn't have defeated you, Bob Barr, back in 2008. Any chance you're going to be resurrecting the campaign for 2016?
No, I'm not going to be able to because I want to take this material on the FDA and write another book. And I'm about halfway through it now, so it's going to... These books take a long time.
Yeah,
I sort
take,
of go into cloister when I have to write these. That's the only bad news about the kind of books I write.
So you were here in New Hampshire for the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance Awards dinner a couple weeks ago. When was the last time you were here? Because Mark said we might have talked to you at the Porcupine Freedom Festival at some point in the past, but I don't recall.
Yeah, that might have been the last time I was there.
What was that, a couple of years, 2 or 3 years
prior?
Yeah,
2 or 3 years ago, yes. Uh-huh. I would have to... I'm not very good at remembering dates of things like that, but I think it was 2 or 3 years ago.
This is where Ian asked you when you're moving to New
Hampshire. No, I wasn't going to ask her that. I asked her that last time she was on, Mark, like 5 years ago. But what I wanted to ask was, you know, you visited back a few years ago. You saw sort of, again, some of the activism that's happening up here. What were your impressions? You know, have they changed at all of the Free State Project since the last time you were here?
Well, if anything, I've just been more impressed. I mean, it certainly is impressive to speak at an awards dinner, as as I was invited to do, and find out that 7 of the state reps have a perfect voting record. I mean, yeah, it's just wonderful. I mean, you know, what libertarian group gives their state reps this kind of rating and awards? It just doesn't happen.
No, it doesn't happen anywhere. I mean, we've asked over and over on the air here on Free Talk Live for anyone to call and tell us if there's any group anywhere out there in all the other 49 states like the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance that rates every single bill that the state reps vote on. They rate all of the state representatives on how they voted on the bills. Are they voting for liberty? Are they voting against it? Dr. Ruwart, if you can stick with us for one more, I'd appreciate it. We'll stand by and come back with more at 855-450-FREE. If you've got a question, get on the phones.
This message is for home intruders, the cowards who break into people's homes to steal their hard-earned property, criminals who shatter lives and rob people of their privacy and security. Listen very carefully. We're the home security experts at LiveWatch, and we're taking you down. Because we're letting everyone try our newest home security system for 1 full year in their home. To take advantage of this amazing offer, call now, 1-800-670-9259. LiveWatch has been helping protect homes for years, and we've learned the secrets that intruders like you don't want people to know. Criminals, it's time for you to be afraid, because every person who calls will be protected against cowards like you. To the criminals listening, we're taking you down. To those who want to help protect their homes, call the security experts to try the LiveWatch security system. There are no long-term contracts, and if you're not completely satisfied, you can cancel at any time. Try LiveWatch now by calling 1-800-670-9259. That's 1-800-670-9259.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition, continuing here with author and awesome libertarian activist, Dr. Mary Ruwart. You can go to ruwart.com. I don't think we've mentioned that enough. That's her website. You can go there, and I believe you can get the original book through that site. At least that's where I got it from once upon a time. Dr. Ruwart, is the 90s edition still there for free on your website?
Yes. Yes, it is. And I think it's as a PDF. And actually, the new edition, which is coming out in about another month, is going to be available sometime this week for 50% off if you pre-order it before it's awesome. Actually, you know, here. So if some of your listeners want to get that offer, they just need to go to my website and sign up for my email list.
Okay,
and
cool.
They will be informed when that happens.
And that's coming up. You're expecting the pre-orders, I guess, portion to start later this week?
That's right. And it'll be 50% off. You can get as many copies as you want. And I'm doing that in part because many people like yourself buy multiple copies for mm-hmm. friends. And I want them to have that option because, you know, once it hits the regular pricing point, it gets a little harder to do that.
So this is the fourth edition. What happens? I've read the first edition. Why should I read the fourth edition? What happens in between?
Well, what happens is I update the chapters. You know, obviously so much has happened. When I first put out Healing, we hadn't lost the Twin Towers yet, for example. So that was an important thing to add. And there's so much more information.
There's also a new cover.
Yes. Oh, the cover is beautiful. Yes. I'm very excited about the new cover. It has the Earth shaped as a heart. And of course, the subtitle is Healing Our World, the Compassion of Libertarianism.
That's great.
And it goes on to, you know, talk about, it says, let's see if I can, I don't have it in front of me.
Yeah, but I'm looking at the cover on your website.
Enrich the poor.
It looks great.
Enrich the poor and enrich the poor, protect the environment, deter crime, and diffuse terrorism.
It really addresses so many great issues. And I did read, actually, Mark, that I read both the 90s and the aughts version mm-hmm. of this. And it was much improved in the aughts version because you're updating statistics, you're getting new information in on the things you've already written. So you're
right.
going over all of the info again anew, and you're bringing new items to light and information to the table, which I think is why you should continue as a liberty-minded person, continue to update this book. Even if you've read it before, it wouldn't hurt to get the new information. And further, this is a book to pass around. I mean, this is not a book. Don't let this sit on your shelf. You should always be like loaning this out if you possibly can, because it's so useful for that.
Yeah, about half of my sales are to people who are either giving them as gifts or loaning them out. So it's really a pass-around book. And, of course, now Ron Paul was generous enough to give me a foreword for this book.
Oh, cool.
Which
Sweet.
Is really exciting. Yes, so there's a lot of, and the cartoons have been redrawn. There's like over 1,300 references of how liberty works in the real world. So no one has to take my word for anything. They can look it up, and you can use those references, of course, when people ask you, especially as a candidate, you know, how could you say that? And you can point to the reference and say, yeah, here's the study.
So you were impressed, you said, more so this time than even the last time you were in New Hampshire with the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance, which for our listeners who don't know, is a group that was formed several years back. It's been around for a while now. I don't know if it's quite 10, but it's a number of them. And
about 10.
It was formed by New Hampshire natives and liberty lovers from the Free State Project, people who care about freedom, who wanted to really have an impact inside the political system here in New Hampshire, where, of course, if you watch the 101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, you know that there are 400 state reps here, which means that each state representative represents so-called a very, very small portion of the population. So it's relatively
about 3,500 people.
Yeah, it's relatively easy for the average person to get elected. They only get paid $100 a year. And, you know, when you're a state rep, you're not a full-time state rep. Most of them are doing something else.
They make $100 a year. You're not
right.
full-time.
Yeah, they have a job, right? So they don't have time to
retired.
Read. They don't have time to read all these 800 bills that have been proposed. So the New Hampshire Liberty Alliance has actually, I don't know, 100 volunteers or something like that, dozens of them certainly, that go through and they literally read all of the legislation. And then they have a system that they can input their opinion about, like, well, this is legislation that would help liberty and here's why, that kind of thing. Or this is going to hurt freedom, or it's sort of middle of the road. And so they grade all of this and then they rate each one of the state reps at the end of the year. And this awards dinner that you were attending is where they release the state rep sort of report card for each of these state reps. And they get between an A ranking or an F, and then below F there's also the ranking of constitutional threat. And
I believe I'm in the only town, I live in the only town that is ranked completely 100% constitutional threat.
Is that right?
Yes.
Oh, ouch.
So yeah, it's a little tough out here on the west side of the state, but there's some places, as you pointed out, Mary, where there's some A-plus representatives. These guys vote the right way, pro-liberty, every issue, every time. And if you think about it, the Libertarian Party, and I'm, you know, I've been a life member of the Libertarian Party in the past, so I'm certainly familiar with it. In 40 years, the Libertarian Party, I don't think, has had the electoral success that the Free State Project has had. We've got more than a dozen people elected right now, more than 15, actually, to state representative seats here. Mary, I mean, is there any other political success by libertarians like that anywhere in the world, let alone the United States?
Not if you use that yardstick. Yeah. But, you know, one of the things that I think, to be fair to the Libertarian Party, one of the things it did, it was the gateway for many, many years.
Yes.
The primary gateway into the movement. Now that's not as true. And I mean, that shows they were successful, because what happened is we've got all those libertarian nonprofits now, for example. We've got organizations like the Free State Project and the Alliance, and it's just wonderful. So
yeah,
now
no
there
doubt.
Are many entrees.
They certainly paved the way. But I mean, the Libertarian Party is a political organization, and you know, after decades, they haven't done what the Free State Project has done in less than a decade.
Yes, there is one area, though, that they have been very successful in and nobody talks about. And I would like to just mention that. What happens with the local libertarian parties is they get involved with local issues like tax increases, eminent domain, things like this. And they have really stopped a lot of that. I know when I was in Kalamazoo, Michigan, we stopped, we ran as libertarians and on the for city commission. We didn't get elected, but we talked about lowering taxes. We called ourselves the Taxpayers Protection Slate. Hmm. So when there was an eminent domain issue, an elderly gentleman came up to me at the meeting where we were all talking about this, and he put $200 in cash in my hand. Remember, this is the 80s. That was actually worth quite a bit of money. And he said, "Dr. Ruwart, I know your employer, Upjohn, is going to benefit from this eminent domain, but I know you are on my side because you are a libertarian. Please take this money and stop the eminent domain, because you're going to take my bicycle shop away."
Wow.
Please. And so we actually, I guess what I'm trying to say is the Libertarian Party was able to make a statement and a name for itself locally. I think this happened in many, many other places.
Sure.
And they fought local things. So that is something. And I know it's happening in the Free State, too.
Yeah, and you can make an impact. And it's harder to measure that, right? Like, it's harder to measure the value of stopping a tax increase, because it's hard to really say, well, it's because of the libertarians is why that thing got stopped. Well, certainly, you know, libertarians have helped with stopping a lot of government across the country.
Well, what I like the Libertarian Party for, and I've never been a member of the Libertarian Party. I'm a Republican Liberty Caucus guy. But what I like it for is that I understand math to some small extent, and I get that my vote on a statewide election is really inconsequential. It's unlikely that the governor of New Hampshire is going to be decided by one vote, mine. So what I choose to do with my vote, when we're talking about races like the presidential one, the governor one, the reps and the Senate and that sort of thing, is if there's a libertarian on the ballot, I'm going to give that libertarian my vote, because I know that if they get, say, 2% or something, it makes getting on the ballot easier. That helps, because libertarians are huge in helping ballot access for all parties. They give people more options. I don't have to vote. I don't have to pick between one of the two pro-war candidates on these national elections. I can just go ahead and vote for the libertarian and actually have my vote count for something.
That's right. And of course, the candidates that do run under the LP banner, if they're candidates that abide by the non-aggression principle, which is happening a little bit less these days, but when they talk about that, they really do educate the public about what it means to be a libertarian. And that is very valuable, because they bring up issues that people haven't thought about. There's so much propaganda out there, you know, to say government is good, government is what we need. We need another voice. And that's really another thing that the Libertarian Party has done, I think, is changed the nature of the debate.
Yeah, I'd like to see a stronger LP here in New Hampshire. Unfortunately, the ballot access laws are pretty bad here. We've got a lot of really good things going for us here in the Free State Project, and there's really great reasons why New Hampshire is the best choice for liberty. But it's like any other place. It's got its issues, and ballot access for the third parties is definitely one of them. So hopefully we'll see more liberty-minded people coming here as part of the Free State Project, because we just crossed 85% of our goal of hitting 20,000 people who are going to pledge to move here. Dr. Ruwart, thanks for coming on Free Talk Live. Always appreciate it. Your website, ruwart.com, R-U-W-A-R-T.com. Dr. Mary Ruwart has been with us here, and you can go and sign up for her email list. That way you can get the heads up on when her new book, The Pre-Order Phase, starts. You can get 50% off, which is pretty awesome. Thanks, Mary, for coming on.
Well, thank you for having me.
We'll see you whenever we see you. More coming up with more Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys, I'm Tim Baker.
I'm Daniel Brown.
And I'm Sean Stewart.
And we are the You, Me, and BTC podcast.
Cryptocurrency decrypted.
Us three chumps love to talk too much, and for some reason other people seem to enjoy it.
That's why we started You, Me, and BTC,
which is your Bitcoin and Liberty podcast.
Find our show at youmeandbtc.com every Thursday.
We also post Bitcoin-related reviews, opinion articles, and much more.
Subscribe, like, and follow at youmeandbtc.com.
How fast are Allegra gel caps? It's raking the leaves and loving it fast. How strong are Allegra gel caps?
I'm running with my favorite workout partner, Strong.
Non-drowsy Allegra gel caps give you noticeable relief of your toughest allergy symptoms. It starts working in just 1 hour, 2 times faster than Claritin's first dose, and stays strong for 24 hours.
It's saying yes to pick up football with the guys, Strong.
Allegra gel caps. Nothing's faster, nothing's stronger. Among OTC oral antihistamines. Use only as directed. Visit Allegra.com.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. On Friday, gold closed $8.20 higher at $1,101 per ounce. Silver was even at $14.73 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $292. Robertson Roberts Brokerage. When you're serious about precious metals, whether you're buying or selling, give us a call. 800-874-9760. Or for more information, visit us online at rrbi.co.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.69 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $293. Antiwar.com reports the province of Taiz in southern Yemen has been a battleground for weeks, with the Houthis controlling much of the city and fighting against a combination of local Sunni tribes and pro-Saudi forces loyal to the former Hadi government. Saudi warplanes got involved in a big way recently. As usual, the result was an absolute disaster as Saudi warplanes attacked and leveled a heavily populated residential neighborhood in the port city of Mocha, killing at least 120 civilians and wounding 150 others. The local hospital naturally was overwhelmed by this huge influx of casualties, and witnesses described animal-drawn carts dragging the badly burned bodies around to hospitals in the area. The provincial capital of Taiz, with its bigger facilities, is said to be unreachable because of heavy fighting along the road. Mocha is near the port city of Aden, which Hadi forces recently seized much of, and Saudi airstrikes began targeting the Houthi forces defending the town from a possible influx of fighters from Aden. 20 were reported killed in initial attacks before the residential areas started getting hit and quickly burst into flames. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, the nation's first naturally filtered chemical-free public pool opened on Friday in Minneapolis, Minnesota. The Weber Natural Swimming Pool boasts an organic filtration system which pumps pool water through a system of biological filters, including 7,000 aquatic plants. The result of a 4-year project and $6 million in funding, the pool features a traditional shallow and deep end as well as a deeper section with a jumping platform and lap lanes. The pool has a capacity of up to 500
500 people and is capable of holding over 500,000 gallons of water. The natural filtration system, which filters water through plants and gravel, pumps through all of the pool's liquid contents every 12 hours. Visitors to the pool can swim for free, although some strict rules are set to keep the system running smoothly. Minneapolis Parks and Recreation Board said in a statement, "This unique water management system is more sensitive than a traditional chemically treated pool and will require cooperation from the public to stay open. Outside food and drinks, tobacco, pets, and glass are prohibited from the pool area, while swimmers are limited to wearing nylon, silicone, latex, lycra, and polyester swimwear." Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports the U.S. government is violating a 1997 settlement by detaining unauthorized immigrant children, and an order may be forthcoming to require the release of the minors and parents detained with them, according to a federal judge in California. The ruling on Friday by U.S. District Judge Dolly Gee follows an influx across the U.S.-Mexico border of immigrants from Central America. Department of Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson said earlier this summer the flood of immigrants has slowed from peaks last year, but is still high. The latest ruling on detentions represents a defeat for U.S. immigration authorities, who in court filings argued releasing undocumented immigrant children with their parents encourages families in Central America to undertake the dangerous journey north. The judge ordered U.S. officials to present arguments for why she should not issue a ruling to require the release of immigrant children and a parent, usually a mother, detained with the minor. The judge indicated a willingness to implement such a ruling within 90 days. Her 25-page ruling would provide for keeping a parent in custody if the person is a significant flight risk, and in some cases, the decision envisions releasing a child to another family member in the United States. Her ruling is based on a 1997 class action settlement in an immigration lawsuit brought years earlier against federal officials. The agreement requires the federal government to minimize detention of immigrant children. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's now been 7 days since a group of hikers went missing in Maine's Acadia National Park, but rescue crews there are still holding out hope of finding them alive. Autistic reporter Michael Falk is on the scene there. Michael.
Hello, Brooke. My socks got wet. That cameraman gave me new socks. I am fine.
That's good, Michael, but what's the situation there?
The names of the hikers are Casey Allman, Brian Emery, Ashley Thorson. The hikers were last seen 174 hours ago. Since then, three very big storms have hit here. There's a 1.24% chance that all of the hikers are alive. Why are you looking for the hikers?
Well, we're still hopeful that we might be able to find them. There's been a break in the weather, so we're hoping that...
Over the past 7 days, the average high temperature has been 21 degrees Fahrenheit. Over the past 7 days, the average low temperature has been 6 degrees Fahrenheit.
Right. So we did another sweep of the park from the air, but we didn't see anything.
Without shelter, the human body can withstand temperatures this cold for a maximum of 3 hours. Is there shelter in the forest for the hikers?
Not that we know of.
They're frozen.
Well, we like
Shh. This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. We're back. More Free Talk Live happening now. You can join us toll-free on this live Sunday edition. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We had talked with Dr. Mary Ruwart in the first hour of the show, in case you're just tuning in, about the government and how they don't really do much to help the poor. It seems like they do. They got their welfare programs. Like, on the surface, it seems like they're helping people in a bad spot in life. But And I'm not denying that some people who do need help get some from the government. Wouldn't deny that for a moment. But of course, we all know that there's, you know, the system of welfare is rife with corruption. People who are working the system who don't actually need the checks that they're getting. They could go out and get work, but they've chosen the life of welfare. So we know that there's problems with the system, and obviously some people would say, well, you don't want to throw the baby out with the bathwater. We need to keep the government helping people. And if it's fine with me, if you want to help folks on a consensual basis, if you want to voluntarily give money to some agency that is helping folks, then please do that. Just don't force me into a program I don't necessarily agree with. I want to choose to whom I give my assistance. I want to choose the programs that are the most valuable to me and whatever it is that, you know, I find most useful. Right. And my name's Ian, by the way.
And I'm King Mark the First. And I'd like to give an example from my life. Okay. So, you know, there's in many places they have homeless programs, right? Many cities have a lot of problems with their homeless situations. They'll give somebody who doesn't have a house or some place to live. Mm-hmm. But they won't have these requirements. You know, the requirements, there's not enough government bureaucrats to sort of watch them, right, to make sure they're doing the right thing. So, you know, you'll have people who continue substance abuse problems. I don't think anybody's for you know, endorsing that. You'll have people who sleep till noon not looking for jobs because, well, you know, it's easy to sleep till noon. I'd love to sleep till noon. There have been times in my life when I slept till noon. Usually somebody else was paying the mortgage. And so, you know, that's what's going on. That you know, I'm told that's what happens here in Keene, New Hampshire. Libertarians set up a homeless shelter here in Keene to address, because there's nowhere near enough housing for people. You know, basically, the government's just turning people away, homeless people away. There's like 200 people sleeping in their car in the winter in New Hampshire. It's a way to die if they have a car. In some cases, they're just sleeping out in, you know, the woods. And it's not great. Suboptimal, right? Mm. So they set up a shelter called 100 Nights. And that's a, you know, it's a nice name for a targeted amount of time. The 100 coldest nights of the year, they open up the shelter. They open it up in the evening when the sun's going down, and they you know, kick everybody out at like 7:20 in the morning with a cup of coffee.
Yep.
Get out and go look for a job. And they have classes on how to, you know, put together resumes and all the things that you do to teach somebody to get a job. But basically, I think that the single biggest and best thing that they do is goodbye, right? It's time to go look for a job.
They don't let someone get comfortable in the shelter and,
sure,
you know, sort of create their own place that they keep coming back to.
You're
not going to get the same bed twice.
Right. I mean, they're just, it's just a, there's a place to sleep,
yeah,
and they've got beds, but it won't be the same one that you're on.
Right.
You also don't get to keep your own personal property while you're in there. I know they've had a lot of problems with just basically, you know, complaints that somebody stole this or that or the
not
other
a
thing.
Surprise.
Not a problem. We'll just lock that up for you.
Yeah.
And, you know, you need a toothbrush. You want to watch some TV? Excellent. We've got those things for you. And it is, you know, it's a warm place to be, but not so pleasant that you're like, you know where I want to go hang out?
100 Nights
shelter. And, you know?
Yeah, I think they've done a really good job with it.
And
that's why I support them.
And I've seen Salvation Army run good operations too. So, and Salvation Army, I always donate to Salvation Army because they helped me when I was in prison. Mm. It was a big deal to me to get that pair of socks and a little peppermint candy and, you know, some pens and that I could write and writing paper and stuff, you know, and be able to just have a, you know, a Christmas. And that's what they did for me. And so Salvation Army will always get money from me for that very reason. But these are the differences when you're talking about who do you want to give your money to? Do you want to give your money to the organization that lets homeless people, some homeless people, I'm sure not all of them, sleep until noon?
Mm.
Or do you want to get the one that kicks them out at 7:20 in the morning with a hot, warm cup of coffee in their hand? Now, by the way,
I want the one that will encourage more responsibility. So the former.
Just as a point, sometimes when weather's bad, like really bad, they don't have to get out at 7:20.
Oh, is that right?
But,
okay.
Yeah, it's not ever, right? Like it's not if it's the blizzard's on and hail's falling out of the sky or anything like that. They do, you know, there's human beings that make the decision,
right,
but generally that's the case and it's very effective.
Yeah, I totally agree. So here's some other news since we've been talking about the government supposedly helping the poor. A lot of people have been all about these minimum wage increases. Mm. Seattle, San Francisco, there's proposals.
People are talking about, you know, what great, you know, what a great thing these things are. Look at all the successes.
$15 an hour. I mean, who can argue with that? Who wouldn't want to double their wage, right? Because
I can't.
The federal minimum is $7-something, right? That's what it is, I think, $7.50.
I think so.
Whatever. And now it's $15 in Seattle, according to the
I wish I got a you know, guaranteed hourly wage. Sadly, I don't get that. I run my own business.
According to the news over at foxnews.com, Seattle's $15 minimum wage law is supposed to lift workers out of poverty and move them off of public assistance. But there may be a hitch in the plan. Evidence is surfacing that some workers are asking their bosses for fewer hours as their wages rise, in a bid to keep overall income down so they don't lose public subsidies for things like food, childcare, and rent. According to a home nursing nonprofit, Full Life Care, they told Cairo Television in Seattle that several workers want to work less. Jason Rantz, the host of the Jason Rantz show on Cairo FM, said, quote, if they cut down their hours to stay on those subsidies because the $15 per hour minimum wage didn't actually help them get out of poverty, all you've done is put a burden on the business and have given false hope to a lot of people. So if the idea was that, hey, you're going to make more money now because of this minimum wage increase. Okay, well, I was working 40 hours a week, but now I can only work 25 hours a week because I'm making more money, and so therefore I want to keep getting my welfare checks. I mean, ultimately, isn't that something that someone on welfare would want? They would essentially be, you know, working less, making the same amount, and collecting the welfare checks.
Well, yeah, I mean, what people are going to do, and there's nothing wrong with this, is they're going to try to figure out how do they get the most money.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't doubt for a second that if people on welfare, and you know, if receiving all these different types of subsidies, had the opportunity to earn more money, then that's what they're going to do. They'll get rid of welfare and they'll earn more money in most cases. But when you say, look, you have a choice of working 25 hours a week and getting your subsidies, which will amount to more than if you work 40 hours a week, which are you going to pick? Are you going to pick the full-time job, or are you going to pick the, you know, the benefits with these, you know, these things too? Or can, you know, I mean, if your kid gets sick, It can be very difficult.
Yeah,
so,
that's a good point.
Yeah, I mean, it's I don't begrudge people choosing this. It's just that the government throws the incentives off every single time.
The twist is just one apparent side effect of the controversial yet trend-setting minimum wage law in Seattle, which is being copied in several other cities despite concerns over prices rising and businesses struggling to keep up. We've already heard, at least I saw something about Chipotle in San Francisco, has already increased the prices on the menu because they've got to make up for having to pay the employees more, which means you, the customer, get to pay more to go and eat at these places.
I doubt those places, just guessing, I doubt that those places were paying $7.25, right? Like San Francisco, it's unlikely
I bet you're right,
that you can earn $7.25 in San Francisco just because the wages are already higher there. But the difficulty is, and what nobody ever mentions, is the minimum wage isn't intended to be a living wage. Now, I've said this several times. We've been talking about the minimum wage over the last couple of weeks, and this is really important, people. I know you want to earn money. I want to earn more money too. We all want to earn more money. Raising the minimum wage isn't what we're talking about here. The minimum wage is supposed to be a wage for basically young people coming into the marketplace, maybe somebody coming from a foreign country who has language issues or whatever it might be. But the idea is that you're not supposed to be raising a family on minimum wage. If you're raising a family on minimum wage, you need a better job. You need better job skills.
Our toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you disagree and you think the minimum wage is a good thing. Just, you know, we got to look a lot harder for all the supposed benefits because there's some other problems. We'll tell you about it here in moments. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE or join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth.
According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2237 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenevention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallow Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info. Visit keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenevention.info. keenevention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.fm Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The live Sunday edition of the program. We're talking about the minimum wage. The $15 an hour minimum wage in Seattle, San Francisco, it's happening in other places as well. And guess what? There are consequences, economic consequences, that cannot be avoided when you meddle with people's businesses like this. One of those consequences, apparently, welfare recipients are now asking for their hours to be cut. Oh yeah, they're making more per hour, but now they don't want to. So much anymore, because they just now realize that, oh crap, if I go above this certain amount of income, all of a sudden I don't qualify for the welfare payments I've been getting previously.
Right. And I'd like to say I don't begrudge people welfare. That's not what my problem here is. My problem is that, you know, what we're doing is incentivizing people not working. You don't want to do that. That's a really bad idea.
And the idea was that the minimum wage would incentivize them to work, but instead they're incentivized to stay with status quo.
I read some article, and I don't have it sitting here in front of me, so I don't know the guy's name, but I think he was involved in either Amazon or the creation of Amazon or eBay or something like that. And he's, you know, a wealthy guy, and he's basically saying, we need the minimum wage. We, the rich people, need the minimum wage in order to get keep the poor people from rioting and killing us all. This was essentially what the premise was on his article. It was a pretty big – it got a lot of distribution.
Why would the minimum wage – stop a riot.
Essentially, you know, the dissatisfaction between rich and poor. Right now, in the United States, the disparity.
But that won't stop poor people, right? Like, I mean, just because you raise the minimum wage, you're saying he doesn't understand economics, this guy, because you raise the minimum wage, poor people stay poor because they have more money in their pocket, but the money has to go to buy things that are now priced higher because of the increase of the minimum wage.
The really cool thing about writing an article is you don't have to answer your critics, right? You write the article with all the premises that you involving all the premises that you write it around, and then somebody may write a rebuttal article or whatever.
And you can ignore that.
Right. Those things don't matter. See, the thing about a radio program like Free Talk Live, where you can call in at 1-855-450-3733 is you can, like right now, you think that the minimum wage is a really fine idea, you can call in right now and explain it to us, hold our feet to the fire. If we say something that you don't agree with, you can rebut that.
Yeah, I don't know if Justin in Winona, Minnesota, Minnesota? Where are you, Justin? Are you in Minnesota? Where are you calling from? Okay, great. So I don't know if Justin is in favor of the minimum wage, but he is on the line. Go ahead with your thoughts.
I am in favor to a certain degree. I think it's a little extreme because they're not taking into consideration like food service. I spent a lot of time at food service. Like as I was a lead chef before, I worked my way up. It has a profit margin that's very, very thin.
Yeah, yeah.
And if you start raising those wages, you're going to start decreasing the amount of waitresses that are serving your tables and everything like that. And, you know, these luxury items like fast food and everything is going to get expensive, and it's going to be even more of a luxury.
Aren't waitresses, I mean, wouldn't it be like cooks, busboys, cooks, mm-hmm. dishwashers, the back of the house folks that would be cut because the waitresses, you know, they're mainly getting paid by tips.
Well, to a certain degree, like in Wisconsin, right across the river from where I'm at, their minimum wage for service jobs is still somewhere around $5 an hour.
Oh, man, it was $2.13 last I looked.
Wow.
I mean, it's, you know, it's still pretty low. And yes, they make tips, like a cook is not. But in Winona, your average cook is only going to make $9 an hour. Now, what if that person wants to be a cook? If you're a dishwasher and you're okay with being a dishwasher, then you deserve to be a dishwasher. And you deserve to make $8 an hour. But if you want to excel at something, you know, and improve your career, like you guys said, yes, that's what minimum wage is for as an entry-level position. It's not meant to.
Well, but what it does is it cuts people out of the marketplace. There are people who are willing to work for less than the minimum wage, and people who would.
Especially during an economic contraction like we have had recently.
Who wouldn't mind employing them at less than the minimum wage, but they are prohibited from doing so by law. Men with guns will come in and point them at you if you continue to do, to pay somebody less than the minimum wage, even if they are willing to accept less because they're wanting to be super competitive, or maybe their skills are just that poor, you know, maybe they're crippled or something like that. Who knows? Justin, anything else you want to share? Go ahead.
You know what? I think what would be a better solution is, because you guys kind of mentioned this, you know, with it needs to be, you know, an entry-level position. Instead of upping this minimum wage to a fairly drastic level, almost doubling it, what about creating programs for people to get into career-oriented jobs? Like the IT field right now is in dire need of more and more people. Construction field. I mean, there's healthcare field.
Well, you don't need a government program to do those things, right? There are already programs where you can go and learn how to program. You know, there are self-training programs. There are schools that you can attend. That, you know, anybody that wants to pursue those careers certainly can.
Kids learn coding.
No, couple it.
What's
couple
that?
It with, I was going to say, you can couple it if you're on welfare, and in order to stay on it, you have to better yourself. If you're not bettering yourself, well, then you are forced to come off of it.
They don't require that in all welfare programs, do they? I mean, obviously, there are plenty of people who aren't bettering themselves. You're talking about what you want to see? That's what you'd like to see happen?
Yeah. I think that would give people the incentive to stop using it and get into the workforce in a real sense instead of like making Walmart their career.
Justin, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a career at Walmart, right? Like, they pay actually above the minimum wage, I think, when you start.
In many cases.
But
not all of them.
There's opportunities for advancement. At Walmart, there's nothing shameful about them. There's nothing shameful about washing dishes too. Somebody out there loves to wash dishes.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know much about Walmart, but I believe some people do that. Do it for the benefits too. Not exactly sure what's involved.
Conan
there.
Was an overnight guy at Walmart for a long time, our Tuesday night co-host.
But what I can say is that you need to. The United States is a big place, and you need to be able to have flexibility in what you pay people. The minimum wage, by its very definition, adds rigidity to the pay scales. So you're talking about. People in rural Mississippi aren't going to get the same pay as somebody in San Francisco. It's just, it's different. And people have different skill sets, people of different ages. They need to be paid different wages. And that's ultimately what comes down to when you have an economic contraction like we had a couple of years ago. Then anytime you have a surplus of anything, the cost of that thing comes down. It's called supply and demand, and I don't care whether you're the government, you're a progressive, you're a conservative, or what you are, the laws of supply and demand do not bend for you. And so that means that the cost of labor went down. At that point, you have, yes, 30-year-olds with heads of household working for minimum wage. It's not because minimum wage is bad. It's because you have now priced all the kids out of the minimum wage jobs. Right. If you lose your job at the factory or the construction job and you go take a job at McDonald's, I got news for you. That job was meant for a kid. Mm. And there's nothing wrong with taking that job. And there's nothing wrong with McDonald's giving that job to somebody who's willing to take it. It's just that because of the minimum wage, McDonald's was forced into a situation where they're going to take the older, more responsible person.
We'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. Bring up whatever you want. You don't have to talk about the minimum wage, the government actually hurting poor people. Now, they would say they intend to help them. I mean, some would say the government intends to help poor people. I would say that that's not always true. I think a lot of the times the government's intending to protect established business people from those upstarts that might be created by poor people. It's Free Talk Live.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Hello, IRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Hi, I'm Darryl W. Perry, and I need your help to give away my newest book. Yes, you heard that right. I want to give away my newest book, A Rebel's Journey. The book describes my path to the ideas of liberty, which began as a search for traditional values. I will only give away the book if I reach my fundraising goal of $2,500.
But wait, there's more!
If you donate, not only can you get the ebook and the audiobook for free, but you can get bonus audio content, including interviews with Jeffrey Tucker, Lynn Ulbricht, Ben Stone, Gardner Goldsmith, and Stephen Kinsella. Or you can get a signed copy of the paperback book and more. Your donation will serve to replace the profits I would have earned through a more traditional publication of the book. The funds raised will allow me to get the book into the hands of more people and to promote the book to a wider audience. To find out more about the book or to donate, visit arebelsjourney.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
Talk Live. You can dial in here toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about the minimum wage, which in some cities like Seattle is now $15 an hour. Well, guess what? There are consequences to meddling with the economy, and you know, government politicians don't have to worry about those consequences. They're the ones who are benefiting from all of the publicity around raising the minimum wage. They benefit because they get to get on, you know, behind some podium somewhere and talk about how great they are for helping the poor people, when in reality, the minimum wage actually hurts the very people it's intended to help. And of course, the politicians can conveniently ignore that and then can continue to push for higher minimum wages so they get reelected, and then they can keep rewarding their friends and punishing their enemies, which is ultimately why they took office, not to actually help anybody, at least any poor people. I don't think that is the case about politicians. I think that, you know, they are in it for themselves. They're not actually in it to help the poor, and these policies actually hurt them. We're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. I also want to invite you to ProXPN. It is a global virtual private network, and you can go to proxpn.com/FTL, and right there, get signed up, get started with ProXPN. Grab their software for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux, whatever you're using. ProXPN.com/FTL is where you can get started, and they will encrypt your internet connection, which means that people who might be spying on you on the internet, like your own internet service provider, probably logging all the websites you visit and the search terms you enter, those people will be stopped because you're going to be encrypted and they won't be able to break that encryption. So go to ProXPN.com/FTL. Stop the prying and the spying and do it for free. You can start for free right now, but when you're ready to upgrade to get unlimited bandwidth servers around the world, you can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. Use code FTL50, FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off. And that gets you 50% off the regular monthly price when you buy their annual account. And that price is good for the lifetime of your account. So even when you're ready to renew for year number two, you get the same awesome deal. ProXPN.com/FTL. There's a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits. Don't forget promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy that is priceless at ProXPN.com/FTL. Let's go to the phones and to the fun. We've got Jeff. He's in Elgin, Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Jeff.
Hi, you guys.
Welcome.
I'm more into the more into the idea of maximum wage than minimum wage. I used to work at a soap factory and made $19 an hour. I left to do wood carving, and I was supposed to make hundreds of thousands of dollars a year, but that's never happened yet. So,
what is a maximum wage? You mean you support the idea of preventing someone from making more than a certain amount?
No, I mean, I'm just saying, you know, the idea of educating yourself and making yourself as valuable as you can to the market so that you can get a, what is maximum of a wage as you can.
Oh, okay. That's okay.
Not government involving itself.
Gotcha. Yeah, but some people do have the theory that there's only a certain amount that a person should make, and then after that, it, you know, maybe the government taxes them at 90% or something. So,
yeah, there's a lot of indignance about people making, you know, more than $1 million a year or whatever.
People really hold it against them. Go ahead.
When they have this minimum wage, they're probably bringing other people down who might be paid more as possible as a result of it. That's one consideration.
Yeah. So what you're saying is that somebody, I think Ian's used the example, you know, if we're at $7.25 currently, somebody works their way up to $9 and then $9 an hour, and then they move the minimum wage to $9 an hour, it's unlikely that the person who is getting $9 is going to be bumped to $11. It's just that all the other people that he or she performed better than have now been moved up simply by dint of law.
It only helps the people who are less productive or and somehow are not as valuable to the marketplace.
And a lot of them are going to get their jobs cut too, because you know if you can only afford to pay four employees before the raise of the minimum wage, and then after the raise you can only afford to pay three, somebody's going to have to go, and then those other three will get to have increased responsibilities.
Yep.
Another thing is, the word Soviet means a local bureaucracy that you have to ask for permission to do everything. Does that sound familiar? we're guaranteed an American form of government, you know. And in like in Illinois, we have the best politicians money can buy.
Thanks for the call, Jeff. I appreciate it. I bet the people in New York would argue with you on that one. And maybe California.
Jersey.
Well. Those are all pretty bad places. All right. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. Let's talk to Rob. He's in Red Bank, New Jersey, listening to WOBM. Hey, Rob.
Hey. Thank you for allowing me to express
myself. Hey, do me a favor,
myself.
Rob. Something's wrong with our phone system here. Can you back off your phone? Because if you're shouting into it, it really sounds awful.
Okay. All right. Let me say this. You know, a social experiment goes, you know, Obama has failed. And this man is doing things for all the wrong reason, and doing it on top of, against the best interest of this country. The minimum wage is a clear, good example, okay? With this, the remaining last 1 year or more to go with this man, things can only go from bad to worse. The recent newscast regarding the ISIS, okay? And you have, you know, the Attorney General, that's that lady, Loretta Lynch, and then Kami, the FBI director, was telling you and I that...
What's
ISIS
that have to do with the minimum wage?
Now.
Well, he's ranting about Obama. This is what Ron always does, or Rob.
You said you can talk about anything,
yes,
right?
You can, but you said there was the minimum wage. I was unclear.
Well, no,
he was tying it in, Mark.
Okay. ISIS?
All right. But ISIS is now not only a greater threat than Al-Qaeda, but an existential threat. Now, I want anyone to explain to me, if that is the case, how come Obama doesn't have a strategy or a plan in dealing with it? Now, while he is in Africa, that's also a threat and an existential threat that he is dealing with. It's called Boko Haram and, you know, the one in Nigeria.
Well, hold on. Let me address this for a second. ISIS exists because of the Iraq war. It wouldn't be a problem.
Okay. He left a vacuum there. Did he not? He left a vacuum.
He left an
American presence in there.
Well, yeah, that much is true, but that's the problem he inherited.
Okay, at least we can acknowledge that.
I don't know whether I can acknowledge it at all because I can't say what would have happened.
You just love Obama, Mark. You're an Obama lover.
No, I think Obama's a terrible president, but I think this poor man is obsessed. But I also think George Bush was a terrible president. Are you willing to say that? George Bush was a terrible president?
He is also that. Yes,
excellent.
Absolutely.
Okay, good. We're on the same page. So would you also agree that we should have no more presidents and abolish the United States of America?
No, I didn't say that. Don't put words into my mouth.
I asked you, would you also agree?
I'm about to talk about the Obama legacy, okay?
The legacy.
Because things are going from bad to worse. So I want to ask this question to the both of you.
Ask the question.
We're engaging here. My question to you is, under Obama's what has actually improved in this country? And, you know, what has things, what things has worked, you know?
Well, the economy is better than it was when he came in.
He did let some people out of prison.
The economy is better than when he came in.
Oh, really? The economy was better than when he came in. How is it better?
Well, more people have jobs. You know, more, there's more sales being done. Not in a recession.
Is that the measure of how the economy is going better for you?
I'm sorry, what was the question? Ask the question again.
Is that the measure of how the economy is going better with you? Because most people have jobs now.
No, yeah, I would say
I don't know. I mean, it seems like it's still pretty bad out there, Mark. I'm not sure if the economy is that much
better. Look, I'm just
and
looking at the numbers.
They're not lowering taxes, are they? So that's not going to help the economy.
Well, lowering taxes when you don't lower spending really isn't much of a benefit, and that's what Bush did.
Is he doing that, though?
Why not give up on this, though, Rob? I mean, why, you know, why do you think that we should
give up
on the United States?
You're implying like I am some kind of a racist. Every time.
I'm not implying you're a racist. I'm implying you're obsessed.
Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. I love his energy. I mean, I'll give him that.
What?
He's like that guy from The Fifth Element, the DJ
Ruby
guy.
Ruby Rod. 855-450-FREE. We got more Free Talk Live on the way.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can bring up what you want. We have been talking about the minimum wage, but you can bring up anything, as our last caller proved. And you can do that also via Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And King Mark the First.
The live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live continuing. What are some of the side effects of raising the minimum wage to $15 an hour in Seattle? Well, those side effects are starting to be felt. We'll tell you more about that coming up here. Also, want to invite you over to freetalklive.com. You can actually get interactive there. There are different things you can do all over the site. But the main page allows you to actually create the show prep that we might use on the air. So you find some sort of article or YouTube video or whatever you want to share with us and our listeners. You submit it via our Reddit-based system. It's free to do at freetalklive.com. Other listeners can then vote as to whether or not they like or dislike what it is that you've suggested. You get to vote on their suggestions as well. So go and get interactive. It's all free at freetalklive.com. Let's go to Sean in Santa Barbara listening to LRN.fm. Hello, Sean.
Sean? You guys got it all wrong. ISIS formed because they just didn't have enough jobs over. They didn't have good work, right?
Yeah, they just didn't have to do.
Politicians said that, right?
Was there someone who said that?
God, you know. Someone said it. Maybe it's Hillary, but
I wouldn't disagree. I wouldn't disagree that if the economy was good in Syria or the Sunni's areas of Iraq, that probably you wouldn't have these guys running around blowing stuff up. But one of the reasons that the Sunni areas of Iraq aren't doing so great is the United States went in and destabilized the country.
That is very true. I agree. But what I really called about was that I just don't understand. I guess I'm kind of baffled. Like, how can we not, like, how do not people not understand that it's just like, it's math, it's science. Like, there's no really way to argue that it is. And, you know, like you're saying, you increase the cost to produce something, well, the price is going to go up. And then, you know, also that these laws, I mean, it's mainly to these progressives and feel-good liberals is like that we can't get through them. You know, these are also based on, you know, these were originally racist ideas. A lot of them, you know, is to pricing out the, you know, quote, lower societies or whatever, lower classes.
They still are. No one will admit it, but they still are. Really, they're intended to price out, the folks, immigrants that don't have the that move here and don't have the greatest employment prospects and that sort of thing. Those people might want to work for $5 an hour, and they can't. And so if they're not racist policies, they are effectively racist policies. Ethnocentric.
Very
perhaps.
True.
So
very true. And then another comment I had.
Well, hold on. I want to address. You said why is it that they don't? How can we get across to them that it's that this is economics is a science, or at least a soft science? Well, I don't think you can. I've talked to many. You know, when I talk to the sort of liberals that I talk to that think about these issues, they'll articulate to you. They won't call the show, but they'll say things like, well, you'd think that that's the way it works with minimum wage. You know, all these arguments that we've made here this evening. You'd think that that's the way it works because, you know, that's what you're taught in economics. But it turns out when they change the economic, they change the minimum wage in Seattle or, you know, wherever they pick the, you pick the place, they'll say, well, look, and look how great it was there. Take a look at what happened in Minnesota and, you know, these different places. They'll point them out as victories. And, you know, nobody, this is the problem with the sort of wars of competing studies, is there's always somebody out there that has some other study that shows some
says
other
the opposite
thing.
Yeah.
Right. And so that's when you're backed into essentially the moral position. Now, the libertarians can never lose the moral position because we advocate for freedom. We advocate for people having human liberty. The progressives will attempt to say, well, you're going to result in robber barons and everybody's going to be a serf. Well, that's the only argument they can come with. And we don't know because you won't let us try, right? Like, I can't take my property and create my own little free nation because the big United States government will come and kill me if I attempt it hard enough to secede. So this is the difficulty. The moral position is nobody has any business getting involved in two people's deal. If I want to pay Ian $5 an hour to sweep the sidewalk in front of my house, I should be able to do that, and nobody should be able to say any different.
Yeah, it's none of their business. Sean, anything else you want to share? Go for it. You had another point I think you wanted to make.
Oh, yeah, I totally agree with all that. And then, the maximum wage thing, too, is something I heard Gardner Goldsmith talk about, is that, you know, these folks who are going for the higher minimum wage, you know, they look at the employers as like an exploiter, you know, purely an exploiter taking advantage of people. But, you know, can't you look at it the other way also and say that, you know, employees are out to exploit employers? And, you know, well, a counterpoint to higher minimum wage, we say, well, let's put a maximum wage so nobody can exploit the employers and hurt their bottom line, put them out of business, whatever, you know?
Yeah, nobody really cares about the employers at all. There's zero care. So, for
instance,
until
you become one.
Right. I'll tell you, I'll explain real quick and make it very obvious. Let's say that no one would say that it's a good idea for an employer to be able to not hire an employee because of their color, right? Nobody's going to say, oh, that's a great idea. What we need is a bunch of white businesses not hiring black guys. Very few people that say that, and the people that do are overt crazy racists. Whereas if an employee, for whatever reason, has, dislikes the color of their employer or their boss or whatever, they can choose not to come into work the next day, and there's nothing anybody can do about it. Right? No one would say, well, you know, that employee should be forced to work at that place because he's quit because he's a racist. And it's just an economic scenario. And these are the advantages that the employees have. There are advantages the employers have, too. But people never seem to even admit the advantages employees have.
Great
Sean,
point.
Thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype. Skype on in here. Username's lrn.fm. What are some of the consequences of raising the minimum wage? Well, a lot of them you can foresee in advance. You know that when you raise the minimum wage, that the business can only do so many things to deal with that. They can cut costs by cutting their employees. They can cut costs by cutting the product quality. Like recently I noticed that or you can cut the product amount as well, like they do in the grocery store. Did you notice?
Yeah, you walked into the studio indignant as you could possibly be that you have found that now the yogurt containers are no longer 6 ounces. They're
now 5.3 ounces.
Found 5.3 ounces.
And that's down from 8. Remember when they used to be 8 and it would actually take you more than a minute to eat the damn thing?
Yeah.
Now it was 6 for a little while.
I'm just annoyed. Like Activia, right? I like the flavor
the Greek yogurt
of Activia.
That's Greek, right? The Greek?
No, it's
Greek
not.
Brand?
Yeah. You have no business talking about this. You always buy the cheapest yogurt. Don't talk about regular yogurt.
That's not Greek. It's not the Greek, huh?
It's not the Greek yogurt.
All right.
And you can't even fit a regular size spoon in this container of yogurt. It's so small.
Right. They're like kitty yogurts.
They
now.
Are. They're tiny little gogurts.
And if you can put a spoon in it, then it always knocks it over. Like, the spoon's too heavy.
It'll hold the spoon up.
It's awful.
I one time I got cases and cases of old expired Activia yogurt. I have a pig
for the
farm,
pigs.
For pig farm. But I'm like opening these things. I'm getting carpal tunnel.
Oh yeah, what a waste.
Opening these things.
The packaging, a huge
trying
waste.
To get the yogurt out to put in a bucket to take to the pigs.
Right.
I mean, these cases didn't produce 1 5-gallon bucket of pig food. It was just outrageous.
It's frustrating.
All
it's
this
so
packaging. What a waste.
Yeah, I feel like I'm wasting my time. I agree with you. Whenever I'm opening up a yogurt and like trying to pour it out, because like sometimes I like to mix in like some berries and nuts and things like that. And you know, I put
think
this
what you're supposed to do.
I've got this bowl and I dump the yogurt into it and it doesn't even fill the bottom of the bowl. You know, it's not even, it's nothing. And of course, it still costs the same amount as yogurt has cost over the last several years. You know?
I know it hurts you, man. I know it hurts you.
It does
hurt. I just like the big
because...
container of yogurt. And you know what? I understand prices are going to go up over time. Just raise the price on my yogurt, please.
Yeah, just raise
the
price.
Stop making the packages so small. This is the reason
they can only do it so much more, right? Like some beers are down to 11.2 ounces. Have you seen that?
Ice cream comes at like 3/4 of a gallon.
Ice cream's been down for a long time.
And they call it a gallon of ice cream. This is not a gallon of ice cream.
They won't call it a gallon anymore. They can't. That's not, you know, it wouldn't be legal to say if it was a gallon.
But people call it that.
Sure.
Give me a gallon of ice cream.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so, we're so inculcated with the notion that ice cream is a gallon.
When was the last time you could buy a gallon of ice cream?
I don't have any clue.
usually it was half gallons that they would sell, but they're not even that now.
I don't know.
They're like 1.75 liters.
Okay.
Right? Isn't it 4 liters to a gallon, if I'm not mistaken?
It's about three and something.
Yeah. So cutting it from liters to 1.75.
There's 4 quarts in a gallon. A liter's
actually, no, they're
four.
1.5. The better ones are 1.75. There's different ice creams out there. There's some that are 1.5. Not even close.
At the least, you can get a spoon in those.
Can't even fit the whole... No, I've got one of those ice cream spades.
Oh,
you can't even fit the spade down at the bottom of some of these ice cream containers.
I don't know why you want flat ice cream when you can get the normal scooper and have ice cream balls.
Spade's more fun to use. I like the spade. 855-450-FREE. We got hour number 3 on the way. You can bring up anything. It's Free Talk Live.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
This is Shaquille O'Neal.
And the Shaquettes.
Reminding you that anytime.
Anytime.
Is a good time.
Good time.
For the cooling, drying, fresh scent of Gold Bond Powder Spray. Like after the gym.
Or a crowded elevator ride.
Or golf.
Or working with farm animals.
Or a hard day's work.
Like sports casting.
You said it, ladies. Stay cool with Gold Bond Powder Spray.
Stay cool with Gold Bond.
Ha ha.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 3 is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at $14.69 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,099 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $293. Antiwar.com reports the province of Taiz in southern Yemen has been a battleground for weeks, with the Houthis controlling much of the city and fighting against a combination of local Sunni tribes and pro-Saudi forces loyal to the former Hadi government. Saudi warplanes got involved in a big way recently. As usual, the result was an absolute disaster, as Saudi warplanes attacked and leveled a heavily populated residential neighborhood in the port city of Mocha, killing at least 120 civilians and wounding 150 others. The local hospital naturally was overwhelmed by this huge influx of casualties, and witnesses described animal-drawn carts dragging the badly burned bodies around to hospitals in the area. The provincial capital of Taiz, with its bigger facilities, is said to be unreachable because of heavy fighting along the road. Mocha is near the port city of Aden, which Hadi forces recently seized much of, and Saudi airstrikes began targeting the Houthi forces defending the town from a possible influx of fighters from Aden. 20 were reported killed in initial attacks before the residential areas started getting hit and quickly burst into flames. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports, the nation's first naturally filtered chemical-free public pool opened on Friday in Minneapolis, Minnesota. The Weber Natural Swimming Pool boasts an organic filtration system which pumps pool water through a system of biological filters, including 7,000 aquatic plants. The result of a four-year project and $6 million in funding, the pool features a traditional shallow and deep end, as well as a deeper section with a jumping platform and lap lanes. The pool has a capacity of up to 500 people and is capable of holding over 500,000 gallons of water. The natural filtration system, which filters water through plants and gravel, pumps through all of the pool's liquid contents every 12 hours. Visitors to the pool can swim for free, although some strict rules are set to keep the system running smoothly. Minneapolis Parks and Recreation Board said in a statement, "This unique water management system is more sensitive than a traditional chemically treated pool and will require cooperation from the public to stay open." Outside food and drinks, tobacco, pets, and glass are prohibited from the pool area, while swimmers are limited to wearing nylon, silicone, latex, lycra, and polyester swimwear. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. Reuters reports the U.S. government is violating a 1997 settlement by detaining unauthorized immigrant children, and an order may be forthcoming to require the release of the minors and parents detained with them, according to a federal judge in California. The ruling on Friday by U.S. District Judge Dolly Gee follows an influx across the U.S.-Mexico border of immigrants from Central America. Department of Homeland Security Secretary Jay Johnson said earlier this summer the flood of immigrants has slowed from peaks last year, but is still high. The latest ruling on detentions represents a defeat for U.S. immigration authorities, who in court filings argued releasing undocumented immigrant children with their parents encourages families in Central America to undertake the dangerous journey north. The judge ordered U.S. officials to present arguments for why she should not issue a ruling to require the release of immigrant children and a parent, usually a mother, detained with the minor. The judge indicated a willingness to implement such a ruling within 90 days. Her 25-page ruling would provide for keeping a parent in custody if the person is a significant flight risk, and in some cases, the decision envisions releasing a child to another family member in the United States. Her ruling is based on a 1997 class action settlement in an immigration lawsuit brought years earlier against federal officials. The agreement requires the federal government to minimize detention of immigrant children. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Patrons at a local Boston sports club watched dumbfounded today as an unidentified man's personal trainer forced him to put on an embarrassing athletic spectacle for the entire gym.
Like a machine, there you go.
According to sources, the degrading little show went on for nearly 45 minutes, with the man reportedly being paraded around every section of the fitness establishment doing anything his trainer commanded.
I wish I could turn around and concentrate on my workout, but I can't help but keep watching.
He has to know how ridiculous he looks.
Sources added that the whole spectacle was made even sadder by the personal trainer encouraging the man to, quote, push himself a little harder.
It's like watching a trained seal.
Okay, so when you stand like that, you want to feel pressure in your knees, like this, right here, okay? Okay, give it a shot.
You root for him to tell the trainer that he's a human being with dignity and just walk away. But no, he keeps subjecting himself to this.
All right, let's have you get on your back, walk like a crab. Come on.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us toll-free, 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about the minimum wage and some of the consequences that somebody could say would be unintended, but the minimum wage has
foreseeable.
Yeah, the minimum wage has been studied long enough now to where if you don't foresee the consequences to raising the minimum wage, you haven't done any research. You know, you haven't really looked into this. You've just supported the minimum wage based on the idea that, hey, it helps people. But wait, no, it doesn't. It actually puts people in a greater more difficult situation because the prices have to come up. You know, if you're dealing with a business that is employing people at minimum wage, then payroll is always the number one cost of doing business.
Almost always.
And unless you've got some crazy debt
manufacturing
payments or whatever. But yeah, payroll's huge. It's a huge cost. And so having to increase the cost of payroll means you got to increase the cost of the product at the cash register, or at the very least, cut it back. Slice it back, cut back the quality, cut back the amounts.
Or go out of business. That's always an option, right?
That happens too. Let's go to Steve. He's listening in Atlantic City in New Jersey to WPG. Hey, Steve.
Hi, how you doing?
Good.
My comment is that besides everything that you said, like the incredible shrinking products and all that stuff, it's also by raising it to from wherever it is up to $15 an hour, might cause runaway inflation. Which might also
wouldn't cause inflation. It would cause an increase in prices. You got to understand inflation.
It puts upward pressure on pricing.
But that's not inflation. Inflation is where the increase of the money supply.
Price inflation, Ian.
Okay, but inflation, you know, as I understand it, is the definition of that is an increase in the money supply. Now, frequently, what happens when the Federal Reserve or whoever is printing the money prints more money, like, you know, in Zimbabwe or whatever, when they're printing more money, that means there's more money chasing the same amount of goods. Hence, prices tend to go up when more money is printed. If what you're referring to is price inflation, then yeah, that would be more accurate.
Yeah,
statement.
But what is true is this Mickey Mouse economics that says, you know what, let's raise the cost of producing, you know, things that people buy, and then the people that, you know, that produce them will make more money, and they'll buy those things at higher prices. So yeah, I agree with that, your assessment.
Yeah, it would go up, but it would go up uncontrolled. What I'm saying is it would control.
No, it won't go uncontrollably.
No, it would not go uncontrollable. You might be confusing the increase in prices based on an increase in minimum wage with something like hyperinflation. They are two completely unrelated.
If you look at hyperinflation throughout the last century, you look at the places it's occurred. You can just search hyperinflation, and Wikipedia has an exhaustive article on it and can show you all the different instances of it. Weimar Germany and Zimbabwe are probably the two most the ones that are most cited.
If you want to see one happening now, look at Venezuela.
Venezuela.
It's getting there.
The problem in Venezuela isn't that their minimum wage is too high. The problem in minimum is that they're putting all kinds of restrictions on the economy, and it is driving pricing up. There's no doubt about it. But really, the problem is the creation of the
strong bolivar.
The strong bolivar.
They got rid of the bolivar like a decade or a decade and a half ago.
This is the strong bolivar.
Hey, Steve, anything else you want to share? Go ahead now.
No, okay, thank you.
Thanks for the call tonight, man. Appreciate it. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. Mary Ruwart was on it earlier. You can sound as good as she does. Skype does sound a lot better than the phones, although thanks to our board op tonight for fixing the issue with the phones. Sounds much better this last half of the show. So our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Daryl actually is producing the show in the background here tonight, and he found an interesting website, mouseprint.org. And apparently over at mouseprint.org, Daryl, the link you sent
was actually for an old article. So they are updating mouseprint.org. That's the good news. I was worried that it might not have been updated in a little while, but it looks like updated as of 6 days ago. This is a website where they actually track the apparently some of the items that are being cut back in their amounts. Like we were talking about how a yogurt container has been sliced back from 6 ounces down to 5.3 after already have been cut back from 8 ounces down to 6 a few years ago. And so apparently there's an actual website that tracks this. It's called mouseprint.org. Very happy to learn about that.
I can't believe it's just difficult for me to imagine. Obviously, these people are pricing. They know their business. What it's hard for me to imagine is that somebody's going to it's expensive to retool your machines and to start making, you know, to set your plastic extruders to a 5.3-ounce cup instead of a 6-ounce cup, mm-hmm. instead of an 8-ounce cup, because they're always changing these things in order to make them smaller so they can keep the pricing the same so they can be competitive. But
right, they try to make them smaller in a way that doesn't look like they're making them smaller, like
right.
you know, like the orange juice container that's gone down from 128 yep. ounces to 96 or whatever.
It's flat.
So they'll make it thinner, but
yeah.
the width of it is still the same, so it looks like it's the same size on the shelf.
Pretty soon it'll be a sheet of paper. it would seem to me that resetting your machines is more expensive than just. Go ahead and change your prices. I mean, I understand prices
yeah.
go up. I know that, you know, minimum wages are changing all over. I know that the government's printing more money. I get that things cost you more. I understand. But I guess it's the comparison shoppers or whatever that get them, because people don't. I don't know. Like, I don't know.
Well,
I
mean, you want to seem like you're competitive, right? You don't want to be the yogurt that's $1.15 when the other ones are 85 cents or whatever,
right.
even though you give more money for the value. I was looking at the website here. Another example. You know how expensive spices are. Right? You ever been to the spice rack in the store?
I go and I buy what my wife says, and I take the money that she gives me.
Yeah. Okay, well, I'm telling you, it's
expensive. I'm like George Bush Sr. who didn't know what a gallon of milk cost. I mean,
yeah.
I don't think that makes somebody out of touch with America because I don't know what a gallon of milk costs. I
mm-hmm.
do see a sign when I go by the Aldi's that says $2 for always $2 for a gallon
it's
of milk.
It's cheap at Aldi.
But I can't imagine that's what people are paying. Generally.
You mean elsewhere?
Elsewhere, yeah.
No, they're paying like $3 for a gallon.
Yeah.
Elsewhere.
I have no idea.
So look,
I don't buy homogenized pasteurized milk.
There's another one here. McCormick pure ground black pepper. Spices are super expensive. If you ever go look at the spice rack next time you're at the store, it's like $7 for, you know, one little bottle of spice.
Okay.
And they knocked down the black pepper from 4 ounces to 3 ounces.
Oh, man.
It's a huge cut. When you look at it from that perspective, Joe is listening in Alabama. You're on Free Talk Live, and they probably didn't knock the price down. That's the thing when they cut down these sizes
no.
to keep the price the same. Go ahead, Joe.
Yes, I was going to go back to the minimum wage aspect.
Yes, sir.
And I hate to turn it, you know, to politicians, but with an election coming up, a lot of welfare checks, benefit checks, they're based on the average pay. So therefore, if minimum wage changes the average pay, they will be seeming to get more money, and they'll vote for the man saying, look what he done for me.
I didn't know that about welfare.
Yeah, I've heard that about unions dues, too, but I don't know the... You know,
yeah, I heard union dues are a multiple of the minimum wage. I don't know if that's
right,
true.
Well, your welfare check and your benefits and you know, your unemployment is all based off of the economics.
It makes
and
some sense.
I was just wondering if that was a aspect that because of election year, if people are going to look as, hey, the man did this for me, we got to get him elected again.
Well, there's no doubt that there's a certain percentage of the population that'll vote for the person who is willing to give away the most. And that's why I'm running for president right now. And
really?
I propose to give away double what Bernie Sanders is going to give away. Put me in the highest office in the land, and I will stick it to the rich people, and I will give you twice as much as Bernie Sanders will give you.
All right, now you're running against your competition over there, Daryl W. Perry.
That's
now,
right.
Yeah, Daryl W. Perry won't give you anything. He's not giving nothing away.
He's a libertarian.
I'm giving everything
Mark
away.
Mark is the king.
I am giving it all away because I think if you're willing to vote for me,
you're a good king.
Because
Mark.
You believe I'm going to give away a bunch of stuff, you get what you deserve.
Right. A benevolent dictator. Joe, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Good call.
Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. So actually this mouse print apparently
my is... entire the whole staff, the every staff member there that I have for my secretaries and all that stuff, it's going to be you know those volleyball players, the professional volleyball players?
Sure, I don't
really
know them. But...
The really nice shorts and the halter tops and stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, those girls are going to run the country.
Not a bad plan. Could be worse.
Yep.
So toll-free number tonight, 855.
Press conferences are going to be a lot more fun, folks.
450 free. Actually, this mouse print site is all about apparently exposing the strings and catches buried in fine prints. It's about more than just, you know, companies cutting costs on their product containers and the amounts. We'll come back with more. You can share your thoughts. Maybe you got a good story to share. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget, freeross.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
back with more Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Maybe you've noticed some cutting back in the area of food products. We found a website here, mouseprint.org, that it's not all about cutting the costs on food, but they certainly do outline some of the sneaky moves that these companies are making in an attempt to try to pull the wool over consumers' eyes. And I imagine it works with a lot of people, but anybody who's paying attention, it's just insulting. And so you can share your thoughts here. Also, we've been discussing the minimum wage and some of the problems with raising the minimum wage. The problem with the minimum wage existing, of course, is that it meddles in people's business. It's none of your damn business who I decide to hire or who wants to come work for me at how much per hour or whatever. It's my business. It's their business, but it's no one else's. And so if people can come to an agreement together without the use of force, without aggression, then that's a voluntary consensual agreement, and you should leave those folks alone. But no, the minimum wage says it's a criminal act to pay somebody less than $7.25 or whatever. In Seattle now, it's $15.
Yeah, it also it's an artificial restriction on immigration too, because one of the big concerns with people moving here, at whatever speed they would want to move here, is that we'd have slums surround cities. There's some evidence for that. There's some good evidence for that. But, you know, you look at historically in the United States, there were certainly slums areas in larger cities, where very low-end workers would live. You can look around the world where they don't have minimum wages and that sort of thing. Not always, but sometimes. I believe there's no minimum wage law, and I think it might be Switzerland or Germany. Hmm. I don't know.
God, how can they live?
Well, they just
aren't they all being exploited by every employer there who's whittled the wages down to 5 cents an hour?
No. I mean,
isn't that what people believe is going to happen without a minimum wage? Is that the evil companies will just stop paying people?
Well,
basically, it's ridiculous.
The evidence to the contrary of that is that anybody makes more than minimum wage, right?
Like, sure.
If you make more than minimum wage, you are the evidence that that wages won't be whittled down to $1 an hour.
Because there's competition for jobs. There's competition between businesses to hire people. And so they've got to offer perks like, oh, you can work in the air conditioning here as well as get paid. Hey, that sounds pretty good compared to working in some sweaty factory where you're not making
without
very much.
Without saws, without using having spinning saw blades
sure.
right next to your head while you're working,
yeah.
right? Like, it's a step up.
So we're talking about some of the consequences of raising the minimum wage. And I should clarify, I said it was $15 an hour in Seattle. I apologize. It is going to be $15. They're stepping it up over time. So right now it's gone up to...
But San Fran raised it too, right?
Yeah, but they haven't raised it immediately to 15. So
okay.
They're stepping it up over a series of several years. So right now, San Francisco, it's gone up to $12.25. Seattle, it's at 11. So over the next few years, it's going to go up to 15.
And these big cities are always going to have larger, people generally get paid more in big cities in the United States than they do in rural areas, and that's just the way that is. So a $15 an hour minimum wage that works in Seattle isn't going to work in Poplar Bluff, Missouri.
Mm-hmm. Some restaurants have tacked on a 15% surcharge to cover the higher wages.
Yeah.
And some managers are...
I'd like to point out on restaurants are already riding the last recession, the Great Depression. The reason that...
What do you mean they're riding it?
They're riding it. Okay, so servers get tips here mm-hmm. today because restaurants back in the Great Depression couldn't afford to pay their servers.
Oh, really?
And so they went to a sort of tipping model in order to keep the business open. And I don't have a problem with, trying new economic models in order to keep your business open. I think this tipping thing needs to go away. It's not done in other countries. We need to get rid of this and the imperial measurement system. Let's go to metrics and companies.
I think you're more likely to get rid of the imperial system.
You're not likely to do either. They're entrenched.
Yeah, but you could.
At this point, we're tipping everybody, though. Like, it's getting ridiculous. I go to a coffee shop. I order a decaf black coffee. All you have to do is pull a handle and put it in a cup.
Well, but if somebody's been super cool and super nice, then there's nothing wrong with giving them a tip.
There's nothing wrong with giving them that.
They're not expecting it. That's why there's a jar there.
When the, right? when the checkout gal at the local grocery store is super cool and super nice, I don't slip her a $5 bill.
Sometimes you can obviously it's hard to do with the checkout girl, but at Publix in Florida, they had a rule that the people helping people, like there's a lot of old people down there, right? So so they've got the bus boys and the baggers,
the baggers
who will go and
they'll
take a cart out and help the old lady load up her groceries. A lot of times they'll offer the young man or whoever it is $20 or some amount, $10 as
many
a tip.
Businesses have a no tipping policy for their
right, and they've
baggers.
Been told they can't take that. So you would have to slip it to them, but it can be done. I mean, you know, if you know,
I
right
just
person.
Don't think. Look, businesses pay your employees what you want them to make. I think that this is getting ridiculous. Where everybody needs to be guilted every time they walk into a business. Well, I do not tip the baristas for making me a cup of decaf coffee.
I tipped the guy today just for getting me a soda out of the
because you feel
lockup.
Guilty.
No, that's not why. Because I want to help these guys out. They don't make a whole lot of money, and you know, don't ascribe your emotions to me, Mark. We're two different people, and a lot of the people in the service industry, you know, they could use a little bit of extra money. So if they're giving you good service, the idea behind
the guy making the burrito in the back is working just as hard, mm-hmm. if not harder,
maybe splitting
and nobody
it with
gives him.
Him
crap.
Hold on, Mark, you don't know what the situation is.
Yes, I do. I've worked at plenty of restaurants.
Excuse me, have you worked at the
not
local
not every
burger?
Restaurant. You're
okay.
Right. I have not
then
worked at every
know.
Restaurant in the country,
right.
You lunatic.
Yeah, you
I'm telling
know.
You that serve yeah. that the cooks
don't
complain
jump to a conclusion.
Across the no, I don't have to jump to a conclusion that you're yeah. a lunatic. I've worked with you for 12 years. The cooks have argued for decades that right. servers make the front of the
I'm
house
I'm the lunatic.
Makes,
I'm the one who's tipping these poor people who are trying to make a little bit of money.
I'm telling you, it's a bad economic.
Your ungrateful butt. They're
I'm
the ones serving you.
I'm not ungrateful. What is ungrateful about what I say?
If you have gratitude, then you show it by giving a tip to the person for doing a good job and treating you well and encouraging
you
them to do better work in the future.
You smile at them and you're kind. That's how you mm-hmm. show gratitude.
Yeah.
That's what gratitude looks like.
Mm-hmm. You can do that and give them a tip so
you
they
can
pay their bills at the end of the month. Yeah, how
well,
about that?
If they can't pay their bills, that's something that their employer needs to address, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Well, already the prices are high enough at a lot of these places, Mark.
That's the point.
I don't blame a employer for wanting to keep the tipping system around. Look, there are problems with the tipping system.
The only people that I see that there's businesses that – tipping is necessary. I tip, bellhops and taxi cab drivers and servers and those folks.
Why is it necessary? Just because it's always been that way?
Well, why don't I feel bad for not going to these places?
I don't know what you're asking.
Well,
me.
If I'm not giving the money, shouldn't I just run around every business that is around there handing out money to employees in order that they can pay their bills at the end of the month?
Well, then you'd run out of money pretty quickly.
That's the point, yeah. is that I want to effectively distribute my money mm-hmm. based on better economic models.
If you
and
tip
that's
well,
what I'm
you'll get
to
better
say.
Service over time, and they'll treat you differently than other customers. So there's good reason to give a tip. There's lots of different good reasons to do it. You can bitch and moan and complain about it all you want, but the tipping system isn't going to go away.
It's not.
So
I didn't claim that it would.
Do you want to look like you're a skinflint or that you're generous? It's
no,
up to you.
What I'm asking is, and I asked a question,
you're
is
the one
how
with the
many
crown
more
on.
Business?
You're
what?
Calling me crazy? 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Maybe you work in the service business and you got something to say to Mark. You're welcome to join us here. 855.
Maybe you'd like to actually know how much money you were going to get paid a month.
$4.50 free, you do. And then the tips are a bonus on top of that.
Yeah,
it's free
$2.13 an hour.
We're coming up.
It's a terrifying thought. You're trapped somewhere without a radio and no access to GCN shows, a doctor's office, the DMV. Your mother-in-law's.
Come on, stay for dinner.
That's what makes the newly redesigned GCN Live app a true lifesaver. Listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programming on your smartphone, wherever you are. Download yours free on iTunes or Google Play. The new GCN Live app. Don't leave home without it.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
Zoo visitors watch the mating rituals of the ice cream shop staff, and a serious coworker puts on headphones to focus on his sandwich. Happiness is perpetually fleeting, so try to savor the next few minutes before it disappears once again. This is The Onion Week in Review. FBI officials announced they just can't bring themselves to bust a man who recently downloaded every season of the 1990s television show Picket Fences from a BitTorrent website. While stressing that pirating copyrighted material is strictly illegal, federal authorities expressed their sympathy for the man and claimed that perhaps the story of Sheriff Jimmy Brock and the strange events in a small Wisconsin town is all he has left to cling to.
We have more than enough evidence to bust him for piracy, but if the poor guy really wants to watch all four seasons of a 20-year-old CBS drama that nobody remembers, he's clearly going through a pretty big rough patch right now. Frankly, we don't need to make it any worse.
For statistical purposes, we have seized all private data from your personal computer, and we are disgusted with your recent internet search history. You sick f***. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. We've been talking about the consequences, the economic consequences of the minimum wage. There are a lot of cities that are getting it in their mind to go to $15 an hour. Now, they're not jumping right to 15. They're stepping it up over several years, but as they have raised it even a little bit, Seattle's up to $11, San Francisco to $12.25. We're already seeing businesses raise their prices. People are getting their hours cut. You can share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE. We've also got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. Mark, tell me about gold and silver. How do you get it?
If you want to get it, you go to gold.freetalklive.com. Gold hasn't been lower in, I think, the lowest prices in 5 years. Now might be the time to load up. gold and silver, both. And you know, if you're not in the market for gold, then you might be able to afford silver. So go to gold.freetalklive.com. We've got great prices and great service there. Midas Resources, we've teamed up with them. I've bought gold and silver with them for years, and we've done business here on Free Talk Live with them for more than a decade. It's gold.freetalklive.com.
All right, let's go to Patrick. He's in Charleston, South Carolina. Hey, Patrick, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey.
Welcome, sir.
Thank you. The problem is everybody keeps looking at this minimum wage instead of looking at opportunity. And it's because of the government there isn't opportunity. There's too many rules, too many regulations. Businesses are dying faster than they're starting. You keep piling these costs onto businesses. The guys would say, forget about it. I'm not going to do this anymore.
Right. They'll either shut it down completely or they'll move to some other country where they can operate it for the reduced cost.
Right. All problems in America can be laid at the foot of Congress, that bunch of idiots that are there.
What people would say, though, is that well, take a look at Europe. The regulatory agency in the European Union is even bigger than the United States. They've still got businesses there.
They've got a VAT tax.
Yeah, take a look at the German worker. They get 6 weeks a year in vacation. Wouldn't you want 6 weeks a year? Wouldn't life be better with more regulation? This is what we aspire to. How do you rebut that?
I don't know. None of my friends aspire to such things. They want to live free. They don't want, have to hire an HR person to deal with all these rules and regulations, which adds to the cost of doing business. Germany, they have a unique system over there where the unions are part of, the government, the company. I'm not sure exactly how it works over there. I don't profess to be a European specialist, but their products cost more for the people that are there because they have all these taxes and what have you.
I think it's a fairly good
report. We're a unique group.
Well, I think America's that the free market different. Tends to work best. I wish we'd give it a shot.
Yeah.
I agree.
And when you see the United States, when you see its most prosperous from 1870 to 1890, what they call the Gilded Era, maybe we could call it the Golden Era because it was very effective, that worker wages doubled in a two-decade period. That's
because
never
of competition,
happened before
not because
or
of,
since.
Not because of a government edict, but because it's just natural competition.
Just natural competition, and the sort of marketplace had matured enough that people could do that. And there's competition for workers.
Patrick, anything else you want to share?
Not now. In fact, we're importing people to compete against America, which causes poor people even more angst.
Well, usually the people that are brought in to compete are poor, too.
Well, I say bring in more competition. Yes, I think that competition's a good thing, and the more competition you've got in the marketplace,
wages down, there you go.
It does, but it also that brings costs down for companies, which means products will be cheaper over time if you keep bringing wages down as well. So there's some benefits to that.
Yeah, in my opinion,
yes,
if you can't,
but it's crony capitalism, and I'm not into crony capitalism.
Well, me neither, but But there's a difference between, the crony capitalists bringing in workers and open borders and freedom. I mean, I would support the latter. I would support having anybody who wants to come in here and, try to make a better life for themselves to be able to do that, wouldn't you?
Well, good. I hope they all move to your neighborhood then.
Yeah, it sounds great. I would love that. I would love a bunch of hardworking, good people coming here to New Hampshire to make life better for folks. That sounds fantastic.
The only way to keep them out is to build a giant wall with motion tracking machine guns.
Yeah, I don't want a police state.
Sharks with lasers.
Hey, thanks, Patrick. Appreciate it, man. Toll free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. It's the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Barry is on the line listening to WIBC. Barry, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, how you guys doing?
Are you listening on the radio tonight out of Indy?
No, I'm listening. Evansville, Indiana, 1280 WGBS.
Ah, okay. You're out by Evansville. Okay, very good. Our board op got the station wrong. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, I was listening to you guys talk about raising the minimum wage and so forth. And I'm a taxi cab driver. I mean, we go out every night. We're self-employed, independent contractors.
Yep.
we use our abilities to be at the right place at the right time, and you know, you have to really stay sharp and everything. There's no one guaranteeing us a wage or whatever or anything else that goes with it. But I haul people all the time in different places, and the folks that are on minimum wage, a lot of them are supplementing their benefits that they get from the government. You know, young ladies that have children and stuff, they work so that they can have taxes taken out and they can draw their earned income credits and so forth. And when you raise the minimum wage, you're putting these people in a situation where they're making more money, and all of a sudden they're dropping out of jobs where they were getting wage increases to find places where they can get less hours and not accumulate as much money. So it's kind of funny how things work. And the benefits, yeah.
They want the benefits because the benefits they don't get charged for. And
yeah, but if they don't get enough hours, they're not going to get the benefits, right?
It's true.
Well, that's true too, but the benefits that they're already receiving from the government,
they'll outweigh that.
They make too much money. Outweigh what they can. So,
and that's what they're seeing happening in Seattle, where people who are on welfare who are now getting more money per hour are asking to have their hours cut because they don't want to exceed the amount that would disqualify them.
So one of the reasons that we have the government so deeply enmeshed in the medical sphere, even prior to Obamacare coming in, was because there was a 90% income tax at one point in the United States. And what companies did was they offered benefits like dental and optical and these sorts of things, and got people reliant on not paying for their own medical. They disenfranchised people from the cost of their own medical care, and instead of because the government disincentivized people getting paid a wage, normally people would want, give me the money, I'll take care of my own, you know, my own health care. But instead, because the government was going to tax that wage at 90%, people are like, you know what, I'll take these benefits. Yeah, sure, I'll take a company car, I'll take the optical, the dental, and whatever else that's out there. And then people became disenfranchised from, they stopped even considering that there might be a cost to their medical. And now we have this culture of people that are big, giant, you know, like in the French, enfant terribles, you know, terrible babies that expect everything to be taken care of for them.
Well, the point I'm making is that if the idea to raise the minimum wage is to help people advance themselves, in our culture, that's not working because it's a deterrent for them to get ahead. If tomorrow I can't hold them in my taxi cab to their doctor's appointment because, you know, an example is, you know, a person making more than $900 in the state of Indiana is ineligible for Medicaid.
Well,
they're constantly monitoring themselves because they could never begin to pay for four children that need medical coverage and everything.
Very good call. Appreciate hearing from you. Drive safe out there, man. Thanks for making the call tonight here to Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The minimum wage is intended to help people advance. The politicians, they want to continue getting elected, so that's why they push it. It's Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Yeah. Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll free to join the discussion here, whether it's about the minimum wage, unintended consequences thereof, or whatever's on your mind. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've also been highlighting some of the product cutbacks where the grocery store or Walmart or whatever, you're looking at the product on the shelf. It looks like it always looked, but oh, the bottle is thinner than it's ever been. And or they just sort of, you know, the bottle might be the same size, but they're not putting as much fluid in, like with the beer bottles that are now 11.2 ounces. Not all of them are down from 12, but you're starting to see it more and more often. So what have you observed? You can share your thoughts here. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
Don't forget, you can join us online at freetalklive.com. And coming up, Keenvention is on the way at the end of October. It's the third annual Keenvention. It's an intimate convention-style event happening here in our very own Keene, New Hampshire, with dozens, what will be dozens, we haven't announced them all yet, but dozens of folks are going to be speaking about various different subjects. There's lots of great panel discussions. You can actually go to keenvention.info, and you can watch 2013 and 2014, all of the panels and speeches from those
Keene
conventions.
Huh?
It's all online. You can watch it all for free.
So go and check it out. You can get a taste of what it's like to be at Keenvention by watching what's happening on stage, but that doesn't really show you everything that happens. You know, we also have the Halloween costume dance party. There are social events that occur besides that. And just, you know, getting to know the people, the activists here in New Hampshire. We talk a lot about them and a lot about the activism that goes on here. This is your chance to meet them in person and discuss whatever it is you want to with them, because every panel is open. There's an open microphone in the audience for anybody that wants to ask a question.
It's hugely participatory, and there's a lot of time left for questions. I think a lot of in a lot of speeches, it's not the case.
But. Yeah, we have long panel discussions at Keenvention, and the speeches are also open to question as well. So it's a really interactive, really intimate, fun event, and I've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed bringing them to
you. It's not just one question necessarily either, because I remember there was an exchange between, not this last year, but the year before, between me and a guy who disagreed with my sort of assessment on how you know, things were going to go in the future in New Hampshire. You know, as New Hampshire became more and more free, he didn't like the way that I put something, and he had an opportunity to get to be heard, and you know,
sure,
that's that.
So go to keenvention.info. You can go there, get your tickets for just $60 for the entire weekend, or Bitcoin equivalent. So if you want to pay with Bitcoin, you can do that. $60 is an amazing price for any weekend-long convention. Go ahead and price it around. I bet you won't find anything that affordable.
No, no.
So keenvention.info. You meet the movers and the shakers, a lot of the great activists here in New Hampshire, and meet some other folks who are thinking about making the move up here. So keenvention.info. We'll look forward to seeing you there. Meantime, we go to your calls and thoughts. Let's talk first to Roger, listening to WGBF in Evansville. Hey, Roger.
Hey, how you guys?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
On packaging. You mean like the half-gallon ice cream used to be 2 quarts, and now it's a quart and a pint?
Yeah, it's 1.5 in some cases. If you're lucky, you can find a company that's still making 1.75 quart ice creams, but they're a little harder to come across.
Yeah, but the real reason I called was, you know, I've been working 40 years, and I know people have been on welfare for 40 years. Why should I bust my butt for 40 years while they sit on theirs for 40?
You shouldn't.
So, what?
I don't know anything. I don't know much about welfare. I remember I was working at a convenience store, and somebody came in and showed me a food stamp. This was back when they had them. I thought it was a traveler's check. I mean, this shows what I know about this stuff. You know, I just wasn't raised to – I wouldn't take a government program for nothing. I'm going to go out and work. Even when I was eligible for unemployment, I just went and got a job rather than taking the unemployment. But I thought welfare was limited in how long you could get it. I mean, I know that there's different programs out there, and they're all sort of called welfare. What, how would somebody be on welfare for 40 years?
Hello?
The generational welfare, people who have sat there and just played the system.
Okay.
You know, you see it family after, you know, it's like having babies for welfare money.
People have, Mary Ruwart, we just had on, she talked about that, yeah.
Okay. And didn't Maine, I mean, I was in New Hampshire from 70, I mean, I was in New Hampshire from 79 to 89. And I think when I left, and didn't Maine start work to welfare in like 1990, and it lasted for about 2 years?
No idea.
What would that have been, where they were encouraging people to get on welfare? I'm not sure.
Get off welfare by going to work.
No, work to welfare to work.
Oh, welfare to work,
It was weaning them off. So they say, you know, I've heard they make as much as $48,000 a year, and I don't make that work.
I can't imagine. Man, oh, man.
Between the money, the benefits, the housing, the medical, and my other question, and, you know, that was the guy's point about the illegals coming in, taking our jobs, and, you know, I don't have the statistics, but how many illegals, you know, they've been the big push on Steinle getting killed in California by the illegal.
Can we stop this illegal thing? I mean, we're talking about human beings here. I mean, have you ever broken a law before?
Yeah.
Okay, then you're an illegal. Welcome to the club.
And if I did, I paid for it.
Oh, well, no, you didn't.
Most
Come
people
on.
Don't.
No, you don't get caught most of the time. You speed, and you and I both know that.
it's a term that people use. I understand you don't like it.
It's a very negative term that collectivizes people and acts as though all people who come here and break some stupid government law to come here to try to make a better life for themselves are somehow criminals, and that they're somehow, you know, a dangerous group of folks, and it dehumanizes them. And I don't appreciate it. And by the way, they're not your jobs. You don't own the job.
They listed about 30,000 that were illegal and should have been deported and have been ignored, and then we have innocent American U.S. citizens getting killed.
Well, okay, you know, so the American Conservative Magazine. Killed. Look, I know Donald Trump is trumpeting this, but the American Conservative Magazine went through and they did a study on Hispanics and whites and blacks, and they looked at the truth about whether or not. They can't tell you how many illegals kill people, but they can tell you how many Hispanics do, and that's usually what people are talking about. And the fact is that there is no noticeable difference between the crime rates in white communities, committed by whites, and versus the crimes committed by Hispanics. So I don't think that there's...
Okay, well, the other thing I called in on was, you know, the Obamacare was supposed to cut everybody's insurance rates, and they say most people's going up $1,500, $2,500. Yeah. I was in New Hampshire. I was working at Seabrook Nuclear Power Plant.
Yeah.
And there was 5,000 people working with UENC, United Engineers and Contractors. I don't know if that was just our location or nationwide. I know there were 5,000 at Seabrook. But we had Blue Cross Blue Shield 80-20 for, like, it was either $4 a week or $4 a month. So if they just dump 40,000 insurance paying patrons on, why did the insurance rates go up instead of go down?
Because whenever you get the government involved in anything, costs go up.
Hey, I'm with you on the Obamacare.
They're a monopoly.
Thanks, Roger, for the call tonight. Well, it's not quite a total monopoly because you still have a few insurance providers, but the way the things are going, they're encouraging those insurance providers basically by virtue
the
of the fact
they're
forcing them to.
Who gets a license? And
that's what I was going to say, is there are very few insurance providers, and over time, they're going to be buying each other out. Because essentially these companies can't afford to do business if they're forced to accept new clients that have pre-existing conditions. You know, that's going to be that's a ticking time bomb. Eventually, these companies are not going to be able to get people to pay them the rates that they need to pay out what they have to pay out in claims. And so they're just going to gobble each other up until there's one or two left. And we're almost at that point, it seems like, in some places. I remember when I looked for health insurance in New Hampshire several years ago, there were only two real choices that were in the marketplace. So you're going
to
see
fewer. States need to open up and allow competition, intrastate competition. But
you're
going to
see fewer and fewer options on the marketplace the more the government gets involved in regulating this, until there's no more choices, and then the government can take it over completely and make it even worse. Austin is in Evansville also listening to WGBF. Go ahead, Austin. We're short on time.
I just wanted to let you guys, I wanted to hear your opinion on Switzerland. I would say most people consider Switzerland a first world country, and from what I was aware of, they don't have a minimum wage.
Yeah, I think I wasn't sure which country it was. I thought it might be Germany, but I did mention Switzerland, that they don't have one. And somehow, you know, they do very, very well there.
My board op is telling me, Mark, that Switzerland does have some sort of collective bargaining between government and business regarding wages. So Okay. Maybe they don't have a minimum wage that we know of, like that we are used to, but maybe they have something that's similar, but not quite.
We've got an amplifier who lives over in Switzerland. We should ask him about
Austin, it. Austin, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. We're out of time for now, but we'll be back tomorrow night. You can join us online in the meantime over at freetalklive.com and enjoy what little remains of your weekend. See you tomorrow.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love, and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way,
love as your guide,
and liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site; two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com; three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free super saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, July 26th, 2015. Silver is trading at 14.